Will Joe Biden last a whole term?
Yeah, that's a good one.
And I emailed you the Rush clip, so you can have it.
Oh, good. Thanks. Thanks. And I'll call for it, too. Thank you.
Yeah, so I just broke it up into two parts because he reads your entire column. Did you hear it live? Howie?
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
What deal can we have, Crazy Nancy?
The Constitution does not say that a person can shout wolf in a crowded theater.
But to be clear, you're not taking any arrows out of your quiver. You're not ruling anything out.
Good morning. Sunday morning.
Chocolate.
Candy,
chocolate, and then we have some other chocolate here.
Consistently practice social distancing.
Why does AOC complain that you have not been grooming younger people for leadership?
I don't know. You'll have to ask her.
That was kind of sharp.
I'm not a big needle taker. Years here. I'm not a big needle taker.
Mother Earth is angry. She's telling us.
What do you think is causing this erratic behavior?
I think that the president has always had erratic behavior.
I have ice cream in my freezer. I guess that's better than having Lysol in somebody's lungs.
Civilization as we know it. Is that
safe? I don't drink, but I'm happy to have ice cream with anybody anytime.
Here at the Howie Carr Radio Network, we're all about saving you money. We want you to cut out the middleman and buy direct from our great sponsors. And to help you save, I've put together a cheat sheet. For instance, if you go to EdenPure.com, you'll find the Thunderstorm Air Purifier, and you can save $10 using code Howie. You can also get EdenPure's Gen 30 heater and save even more money with code Howie Deal. Do you have a dirty, dingy carpet that could use some freshening up? Head over to Genesis950.com, use code Howie, and get a gallon of their cleaner, free shipping, and other goodies with code Howie. Put a little pep in your step with Super Beats. Get more bang for your buck and do some good for your heart by going to superbeatsradio.com/Howie. While you're at it, give your ears a treat too and listen to your favorite music and podcasts with premium earbuds from Raycon. Get them at buyraycon.com/Howie. And finally, make cooking easier with HelloFresh. They'll send you easy to follow recipes and all the ingredients you need, but only if you visit HelloFresh.com/Howie. Cut out the middleman, save money, and take advantage of these deals now.
Normally, we give Fredo Cuomo a lot of attention, but lately, it's Governor Andrew Cuomo who's been grabbing headlines. Let's take a listen to some of his best moments.
You're an essential worker, so go take a job as an essential worker.
But the people are hiring because of...
No, there are people hiring. You can get a job as an essential worker. So now you can go to work and you can be an essential worker and you're not going to kill anyone.
The number is down because we brought the number down. God did not do that. Fate did not do that. Destiny did not do that.
We're not going to make America great again. It was never that great.
But I can all see you're in masterful shape, buff even.
It has a very...
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
We'll write the next great chapter in the history of the United States of America, the American story. A story that might sound something like a song that means a lot to me.
Please, God, don't let him quote lyrics.
There's one verse that stands out, at least for me, and it goes like this.
Oh, Christ.
Muskrat Susie, Muskrat Sam. Do the jitterbug out of Muskrat Land.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Just wanted to comment. I don't know if anyone else is struck by just seeing everyone masked. Even the Republicans are in masks. There's no longer that social pressure from Donald Trump.
There's no pressure. I am not myself. I feel weak and ineffectual. I'm not Kramer.
Goodbye. We love you. Have a good life. We will see you soon.
I did it my way.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
I did end up listening to the speech. It started, I was listening to a talk show, Chris Plants, and it just cut in. And so I decided to listen to it, and I regret it. I remember the immortal headline that the Boston Globe wrote one time. They didn't mean to put it in. It was just a plug, and it got in. About a speech by Jimmy Carter, more mush from the wimp. That would have been appropriate for Joe Biden's inaugural remarks today. More mush from the wimp. he's calling for unity, and he wants all the unity for the even among us white supremacists, domestic terrorists, racists, etc. And there'll be a lot of unity, but once he defeats the lies, you know, this is the kind of outreach they've got. And they also they've taken over, they've reclaimed their what they see as their birthright. Mitch McConnell, the erstwhile majority leader of the Senate, made a joke about how Biden and Harris were he called them, I think, a son and a daughter of the Senate, which is kind of weird in itself. I thought it was the world's greatest club. Now it's a family. And he said, and they went to the they're coming up here, and they didn't even stop off at the house. It's like being at a fraternity roast, but you're not a member of the fraternity, you know. And we're all non-members of their fraternity, you know. We don't have fathers-in-law who are billion-dollar businessmen in partnership with the Red Chinese like Mitch McConnell. We don't have a crack-addled alcoholic son who got more than $1 billion from the Red Chinese. 844-500-4242. I don't know if you heard this, but we were all thinking of Chris Matthews today. Isn't it a shame that he had to watch it from the front porch of the nursing home that he resides in? Now, I'm more coherent than Joe Biden, and I'm on the sidelines here. You know, remember Chris Matthews is the one who said he got a thrill up his leg when he listened to Barack Obama. Well, did you hear about the New York Times editor? Her name is Lauren Wolf. Never heard of her. You never heard of her. But she tweeted out yesterday, Biden landing at Joint Base at Andrews now. I have chills. Chills. Rhymes with thrills. So she's now deactivated her Twitter account, like so many others. She's taken so much grief. And then we have David Brooks. Do you remember David Brooks when Obama was inaugurated? He knew he was going to be a great president. Do you remember how he knew? He had a crease in his pants. He had a crease in his pants, and David Brooks was so impressed. David Brooks, born in Montreal, but this is the greatest moment in his life since he saw the crease in Barack Obama's pants, cut 40.
Now, as I look at these faces, I must say I'm moved almost to tears by a lot of good people of different political views, but we have leaders who have not been able to be fully themselves. And there are good people. They're chatting, they're talking, they're wanting to run this country well. And this is opening day, and so now I find myself strangely moved and uplifted compared to where I was about hours ago.
I haven't been this uplifted since I saw the creases in St. Barack's pants. But he's not just so it's like a poker game, you know, I call you, you know, and then the next guy throws in a few more chips. So this is Ed Glaudy on MSNBC. Again, never heard of him, never read him, but he's not just a saint. He is actually a deity, much like Obama. Cut 41.
Thinking about all of those folks who, just for the moment, the nation shared their grief. Oh, what a first step. What a beautiful step. So I'm reminded of the psalmist, you know, he heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. Maybe the death will speak to us now. Maybe they can rest now.
Maybe the deaf can rest.
If we do, and I'm sure we can, we can proclaim the palmist.
Yeah, he mispronounced that guy Glaudy mispronounced it. It's palmist. You know that. It's not a psalmist. What's wrong with that guy? Are you more of an Old Testament type person? You prefer Old Testament to these deity references? Well, we have a rabbi who wants to compare Joe Biden to Moses. Cut 42.
Our reading from the book of Exodus about Moses is freeing us from 400 years of backbreaking Egyptian slavery at the hands of an autocratic, cruel Pharaoh. In many ways, dear Joe, you are our Moses.
Donald Trump, the cruel Pharaoh. The cruel Pharaoh. Okay. All right. 844-500-4242. 844-500-4242. I would like to thank Rush Limbaugh for reading from my column. Thank you, Mr. President, today on his show. I was listening to Grace, but I was just she was doing an impression of how I would tell people to watch Boston Blackie. But I'm glad I heard it. So and thanks to everybody who's mentioning it, and that was good. I appreciate Rush mentioning the column, and it's still up on the HowieCarrShow.com website, and it's maybe we should we tweet it out again, Taylor, to make it easier, or is it just easy enough?
I just tweeted it out not that long ago.
Okay, that's good. Yeah, and you can read it if you haven't read it yet. Thank you, Mr. President. I wrote one today just about Trump derangement syndrome, but that's not a bad column either, actually. But if you want to read it, go ahead. And also, we're going to continue our sale today. This will be the very last day for the sale. We're trying to get some cheap bastard deals sold. We're wrapping them up. We have a very, very limited capacity inventory, I should say, for a lot of these deals. But if you order a cheap bastard deal today at HowieCarrShow.com store, just go to HowieCarrShow.com, read the column, go to the store. And if you order one of our cheap bastard deals, we got all kinds of stuff, cryo, wellness, IVs. We got a Ginger Betty's are still left. A couple of the restaurants went out yesterday. But if you order any of the cheap bastard deals today, you will get a free copy of What Really Happened, my book about the 2016 campaign. I mentioned that in my column. Trump tweeted out about that book three times. And as Donald Trump Jr. said, that's twice more than he tweeted out about my book, Howie. So I appreciated that as well. Anyway, thank you to Rush Limbaugh for mentioning the column. And we've got so many cuts to play here today. 844-500-4242. 844-500-4242. Right now, though, listen up. This is the best deal that you are going to be offered all week. Have you been thinking about buying one of the Eden Pure Gen 30 space heaters or the Thunderstorm air purifier? Well, until Friday, you don't have to buy one or the other. You can get both. With code word THUNDER, you will get a free Thunderstorm when you purchase the Gen 30 space heater, which you can see right behind me here. It's very pretty, and it keeps you warm. It's not going to embarrass you. It's extremely fashionable. Look at that wood paneling on it. The home heating prices are about to start skyrocketing. You know, Joe Biden wants to get rid of fracking. He wants to get rid of coal. It's going to be bad. Potentially that's going to cost you hundreds of dollars a month extra. Eden Pure Gen 30 heater will save you up to 50% on your heating bills. The Eden Pure Gen 30 Classic Infrared Heater uses state-of-the-art infrared heat to warm you to the core. It's even been proven to keep you warmer than your furnace and save you money on your heating bills every month.
Howie, this is a great deal for anybody like me who has kind of a finished basement but doesn't have any heat down there. Now I can get the Gen 30 heater and put a Thunderstorm down there to get any, you know, dank, musty smells out of the basement. And I'll be warm at the same time. So it's a, you know, buy one, get one. Everybody's happy.
Yeah, I put mine right in front of my couch. It's not that cold, but I like it warm. And this way I could just keep the thermostat overall way down and stay warm myself just in front of my, just put it in front of your couch or your chair where you're reading or watching TV. The Gen 30 heater doesn't dry out the air in the room. This helps prevent dry skin. If you have pets or young kids around, you don't need to worry about the heater catching on fire. Go to EdenPure.com and put in code word thunder. That's nearly a $100 savings, and shipping is free too. Buy the Eden Pure Gen 30, and with code word thunder, you'll get a free thunderstorm air purifier. EdenPure.com. You'll never be cold again, and you'll never smell that musty odor again. EdenPure.com, code word thunder. I'm Howie Carr.
The Howie Carr Show.
Do you want me to come back with cycles?
Yeah. Exactly. Okay. That's good.
I have a big announcement, and it's somewhere on my body.
Because the biggest purveyor of fake news is the president in this country, because he does it a lot.
I'm just going to speak from the heart here. What we have witnessed was a total eclipse of the fact.
You thought I went hard in 2019. Watch 2020, baby. There's more to come. I'm a soldier. I'm ready to fight.
Talking about the cost of this parade and where there would be tanks, right? And would there be nuclear weapons? Americans, are you mad as hell? I wouldn't normally address this. As a journalist, I don't really like being the story here. Kanye West, entitled to his own opinion, but is not very bright and not very... I'm talking about this issue, not overall. So we have to stop demonizing people and realize the biggest terror threat in this country is white men, most of them radicalized right up to the right.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DeStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great. I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair. For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie. What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out? Get the hair you've always wanted. Hairman.com/Howie.
We are now effective today requiring all counties to close their indoor activities, their indoor operations in the following sectors: restaurants, wineries, tasting rooms. A few weeks ago, I was asked to go to a friend's 50th birthday. I made a bad mistake. Instead of sitting down, I should have stood up.
Stay at home as much as possible. Put those social gatherings on hold, including extra care for Thanksgiving.
Denver's mayor told you to stay home for Thanksgiving, then he got on a flight to go see family out of state.
Some people calling Supervisor Kuehl a hypocrite. Now, on November 24, she voted to ban outdoor dining, and on the very same day, she was spotted eating out.
I take responsibility for trusting the word of the neighborhood salon that I've been to over the years. As it turns out, it was a setup. So I take responsibility for falling for a setup. This salon owes me an apology.
What they do.
We gave you a gun, the authority to use it. One is no good without the other. They don't know that out there. So they'll scream blue murder until the next time they need a man with a badge.
Howie Carr. So I'm down, and so I'm out, but so are many others. So I feel like trying to hide my head beneath these covers. Life is like the seasons. After winter comes the spring.
That's Frank Sinatra, Cycles. I thought that was more appropriate than My Way. I, you know, too many people use My Way. The president used it, and, you know, he took crap about it and all that. And he did it. He mentioned a Frank Sinatra Tombstone line, the, you know, the best is yet to come. That was the close of his farewell address last night. I would have gone with Cycles, but maybe Cycles is a little too down to go with. You know, my gal just up and left last week, Friday, I got fired, et cetera, et cetera. That's how the song goes, but it's really a good song. All right. I don't think he's going to be down too long. You know, he's because life keeps running in cycles.
Mago, Mago.
That's right. The shiny sheet welcomed him back today with a nice headline. Term of American Carnage ends here. That's the headline. It's a news story. It's just amazing. I kept waiting. Does it say opinion here anywhere? The American carnage that is the end of the Trump presidency is slated to careen to a historic end today in Mar-a-Lago. Shut up. Shut up. New year, new hobbies, and everything is better with Raycon wireless earbuds. With up to 6 hours of playtime, water and sweat-resistant construction, and seamless Bluetooth pairing, you can take Raycon's premium audio anywhere you go. Right now, get 15% off at buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Will Joe Biden last his whole term?
No.
96% say no. Not a lot of people have faith that he will. And we're not saying he's going to die during his first term.
Right.
There are a lot of other possibilities.
Right. You know, I said today to Mark Simone, he said, is he going to last the whole term? I said, I don't think he's going to last 2 years. They may try to keep him there for like 2 years and one day so that they can, they have this fantasy that they're going to keep running Kamala for 2.5 terms, you know, she's going to be the next FDR. I guess under the Constitution, if you serve less than half of a term, you can run for two more full terms. But this is, let's just play a few cuts here. We won't dwell on these, but Joe was Joe here today. Cut 20.
We can overcome the deadly virus. We can reward work.
Reward work. Cut 21.
Our history has been a constant struggle.
Struggle. Like Joe Namath, he struggles with words sometimes. And again, he's not a drinker. But sometimes it sounds like he had a couple of hi, how are yous before he went up onto the stand. Cut 22.
And today, we mark the swearing in of the first woman in American history elected to national office, Vice President Kamala Harris.
So it is. Cut 25.
I understand they worry about their jobs. I understand, like my dad, they lay in bed staring at night, staring at the ceiling, wondering.
Like my dad lying in bed, staring at the night. He didn't have enough money to repair the roof. He had to look out. It was okay in the summertime, except when there was a thunderstorm. Then my dad got kind of wet there. Cut 26.
We must end this uncivil war that pits red against blue, rural versus urban. Or rural versus urban.
Which side are you on? Rural or urban?
Is that an MMA fight coming up this weekend? Rural versus urban?
It's a Texas death match.
Okay.
Rural versus urban. Cut 27.
We need all our strength to persevere through this dark winter.
To persevere. And, you know, Mitch McConnell reminded him that he never served in the House. But a few minutes later, Joe Biden forgot that he never served in the House. Cut 28.
Look, folks, all my colleagues I serve with in the House and the Senate up here.
The House, the Wilmington City Council, the County Committee. Oh, who cares? It's all the same, you know. He was in the House. That's the second or third time he's gotten confused and thought that he was in the U.S. House of Representatives. All right. 844-500-4242. How is he? Is he quoting lyrics from the anthem? Is that worth repeating, Taylor?
No, I grabbed that strictly for the intro.
Oh, I see. Okay. All right. 844-500-4242. And, you know, he says that we have to reach out to across the aisle, you know, to the rural versus Erlin. But he seems to think that if you didn't vote for him, you're a white supremacist. Now, it used to be that they would call you a racist. But then they said that's, you know, that's lost its sting. You know, no one, you know, people say racist, they just roll their eyes. Everybody. So they started calling everybody who was for Donald Trump or was not a Democrat, a white supremacist. But that's kind of too many syllables. That's kind of a tongue twister, white supremacist. Who wants to say that every time? So they've shortened it again. Now, terrorists. But it's somewhat confusing because, you know, we don't crash planes into buildings or, shoot people in airport terminals. So they call us domestic terrorists. And again, the Washington Post today, now that it doesn't matter, self-styled militia members planned to storm Capitol days before attack, court documents say. So the impeachment, never mind. I'm Howie Carr. You may have heard that many of the RV and camping shows have been canceled, but don't worry. Cold Springs RV is happy to announce the New England RV Show. This is Howie Carr, and if you're a camper, I've got two words of advice for you. Buy early. With the popularity of camping growing and manufacturers' constraints, the earlier you shop, the better. Visit Cold Springs RV in Ware, New Hampshire to make sure you get spring delivery. Go to NewEnglandRVShow.com to learn about this safe show. Nauset Beach Inn is open for the first time this winter. Take advantage of their ocean view room rate of only $100. All rooms have two queen beds and they're pet friendly too. Nauset Beach Inn is the only hotel on the Cape Cod National Seashore. Contact-free check-in and check-out. Don't hesitate. These rooms go fast. Reserve now at NausetBeachInn.com. That's NausetBeachInn.com.
I tested positive. Let's use this example of me having it as proof that you can get it too. God forbid, the rest of us should be staying at home for our mothers and the people that we love. And to keep us farther apart will ultimately bring us closer together in this cause. We have to do everything we can to avoid being sick. No matter where the virus goes, the way to stop it will always be the same. Our collective conscientious actions. Staying home.
You get Chris Wallace saying it's the best speech he ever heard?
Sure.
I'll send you the should I send you this?
Yeah, whatever you got, you can send it to me.
Okay. I'll send it to you. I just okay. It's in Breitbart, but they got the video, they got the audio. Go ahead.
Thanks.
Oops. Oh, I got rid of my internet. Okay, I can get it back though, I guess. Okay, here it is. I got it. Is Grace coming on?
Yes.
how are we going to pay for it? And like, this is the war. This is our World War II.
I think that there's a lot of people more concerned about being precisely, factually, and semantically correct than about being morally right.
But being factually correct is important.
It's absolutely important.
And if we work our butts off to make sure that we take back all three chambers of Congress, all three chambers of government, the presidency, the Senate, and the House in 2020, we can't start working in 2020.
What impact do you think Russian interference had in the election?
I think it was one of the major contributors to the outcome.
Years from the 2016 election, and Hillary Clinton still can't accept the results. Take a listen.
You know, you can run the best campaign. You can be the person who gets the nomination. You could lose.
I believe he knows he's an illegitimate president. He knows.
The one thing that Trump is fearful of when it comes to his being president is that finally we will see how illegitimate his victory actually was.
This wasn't on the level.
Flashing videos that appear and then disappear and they're on the dark web and nobody can find them.
It's like applying for a job and getting 66 million letters of recommendation and losing to a corrupt human tornado.
So maybe there does need to be a rematch. I mean, obviously, I can beat him again.
So, of course, he's obsessed with me.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
I think people need to be encouraged, reminded. And Howie Carr's column is a good list because it's full of a lot of little things that are big things.
Thank you, Rush, for mentioning my column. I didn't hear that live because I was listening to Grace do her impersonation of me, talking about Boston Blackie. Right, Grace?
Yes, I'm honored that you're listening to me. That's really cool, though. And it is a great column, and everyone should check it out because it does summarize how a lot of people are feeling, especially today, Howie. I sent Corey Lewandowski a text, and I said, hey, awesome 4 years. You guys rocked it. Can't wait to see what you guys do next. And he said it flew by. And that's how it feels. It does feel like it flew by really fast.
Yeah, I know. It did. It always does, you know, when it goes fast when you're having a good time. This next 4 years, I don't think is going to go so fast.
It will go faster if you listen to the Grace Curley Show and the Howie Carr Show, though. I can assure you of that.
Yeah, I really like Donald Trump Jr.'s, I guess it was his Instagram last night. We was talking about the Lion King. Did you see this one, Grace?
No.
He said, do you remember the Lion King where Scar cheated to get to become king? And as a result, the lions lost everything and their country was overrun with hyenas. Just asking. No reason.
Well, I think Trump put it really well today, too, when he said, if they raise your taxes, I hope they don't. But if they do, I told you so.
That's one of the first things I told Taylor to get today. This is a cut
five. I hope they don't raise your taxes. But if they do, I told you so.
And if I hear any of my liberal friends complaining over the next 4 years, I'm going to say, hey, he has really nice tweets, at least, and he's very decent. He's ushering in unity and decency.
Someone just texted me, Grace, and said that they have a moon bat friend who can't bring herself to use the word censorship. You know, they say deplatformed. Talk about a euphemism, right?
Well, Howie, did you see the story that was run the other day in USA Today? And they were saying that people are using the term Orwellian wrong because people refer to George Orwell's 1984. And they say, and they just make reference to it because of the censorship that's going on. And someone else tweeted back at them and said, you guys trying to tell us how to use it, that we're not using the term correctly is the definition of what it is. Telling people how to think. It's really wild. But Howie, I wanted to bring up something on a lighter note. Did you see Bernie Sanders today at the inauguration? There were some wacky outfits. Lady Gaga had on a very interesting dress that people are also talking about. But I think that Bernie Sanders is way more funny. He was wearing a parka and hand-knitted mittens. And he had some sort of piece of mail.
Yeah, I know. What was that all about? That's what I was wondering.
And people
what is he? Is he turning into the Unabomber or something? What was he? He does. You know, he's a senator. He doesn't have an aide that he can give the mail to take down to the mailbox.
See, I actually like this about Bernie Sanders because I think it makes him seem more legit. It adds a little cachet to his socialism stuff.
You mean kind of like stealing the Sunday Washington Post off his neighbor's yard in D.C.?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, it's like, I remember one time the mailroom manager was mad at you, Howie, because you were wearing some sort of sweatshirt. It was all tattered. It had all like a nice green stain on it or right. something like that. And I remember I told my mom and she said, oh, I think that's cute. I think that's kind of Howie's thing. Like, it doesn't matter how successful he is. He still likes to wear his sweatshirts. And that's how I feel about Bernie Sanders. I like that he wears the big weird mittens. But the tweets about this were amazing. Someone said, Bernie's dressed to stand online at the post office.
Yeah.
And he said, Bernie Sanders showed up to the Inauguration Day proceedings looking like a man who was preparing to shovel the driveway, a man who was about to head to the grocery store. And once again, he just looks super grumpy, but he was probably warm. He was probably a lot warmer than the other people there.
Look, he ran for president twice, and he now has three houses, and he's a multimillionaire. I mean, what's his complaint?
Well, he got
every man has his price.
Howie,
Bernie can tell us that better than most men.
He got that from writing very successful books.
Right. Yes, I understand that. I do.
You understand. If you get on the New York Times bestsellers list, you don't really have to work anymore.
No, you don't. Obviously, yeah. Here it is. You know, all these years later, I'm still coming to work every day.
It's amazing.
I guess my bestsellers didn't sell as well as his did.
Well, you're not married to Jane Sanders.
That's right. That's right. The mailroom manager doesn't run a media buying organization.
Can I just do one more note on the fashion front?
Yes.
Melania Trump today looked stunning. She truly looked like Jackie O. She had the big black sunglasses on, the beautiful suit, and then she changed into some really funky Palm Beach dress that she wore when she got off of Air Force One in Florida. And once again, I know I say this all the time, but not one fashion magazine in her 4 years, one of the most beautiful first ladies of all time, and just no respect. But I hope she knows that some of us fashion plates really loved watching all of the beautiful outfits.
I was glad to see her wearing black, by the way. I thought it was appropriate for the occasion.
Yes, it was very fitting. I agree. By the way, Howie, since we're talking about unity, I wanted to tell you the latest bit of decency that I saw on Twitter today. Did you see Stephen King's tweet about Kayleigh McEnany?
No. Stephen King?
Yes.
The author?
Yes.
Okay.
So Kayleigh McEnany tweeted, serving as press secretary has been a true honor. And then she went on to say it was a great privilege and, you know, she was honored to do it. He retweeted that and said, enjoy your next job as a cocktail waitress in Tampa.
Could that be considered sexist if a Republican has said something like that?
Well, when the moonbats in your comments tell you that you should probably stop being sexist, you know you've crossed a line. And a lot of other people were saying, hey, I was a cocktail waitress. Like, why
and what's
that?
Wrong with Tampa, by the way?
Yeah. No, he's really offending just large groups of people.
He's from Bangor, okay? Now, what's today, January 20th? Where would you rather be today? Bangor, Maine? Tampa, Florida? Ooh, I rest my case.
That's a tough one. I'll have to think about that. And another piece of unity, Howie. The Lincoln Project tweeted out today, just now, Ivanka departs the White House for the final time. And it was a picture of a witch on a broom in the sky.
I guess there's some members of the Lincoln Project that really don't like women all that much, do they?
No, but they're pretty fond of the other.
561 says, did Dr. Jill wear her hospital scrubs? Did she come to the inauguration directly from the emergency room? Was she performing some emergency appendectomies or anything like that earlier this morning?
Well, Howie, this morning when I was getting ready for my show, I pulled a lot of sound of, you know, CNN, like Wolf Blitzer. They couldn't even help themselves. They were so rude about Trump. And his remarks and, you know, laughing at him as he left and just really showed their disdain for him. And like he always says, for his supporters. But I couldn't believe the sound cut you played in the last segment. And I think we have to play it again. David Brooks crying.
It's the first time he's cried on TV since he saw The Crease. And that was, what, 12 years ago? 12 years he's been holding back his tears.
It's really amazing. Can we play it one more time?
Go ahead.
Now, as I look at these faces, I must say I'm moved almost to tears by a lot of good people of different political views. But we have leaders who have not been able to be fully themselves. And they're good people. They're chatting. They're talking. They're wanting to run this country well. And this is opening day. And so now I find myself strangely moved and uplifted compared to where I was about an hour ago.
Get yourself together.
Yeah,
get a grip.
I don't think you call it opening day. I know you weren't born in America, but opening day usually refers to the start of the baseball season, not inauguration day. Dave.
Exactly.
Maybe you can go to your citizenship class and, learn some of these little American oddities.
Unless Dr. Fauci's thrown out a whopper, it's not opening day. But that's so really
a couple
amazing.
Of people are mentioning too, Grace. Does Stephen King not understand that you could basically call AOC a waitress? You know, she was a bartender, but it's a very related field.
You know who else you could call a waitress?
Grace Curley.
Grace Elizabeth Curley, one of the best waitresses on the South Shore, some have said. But here's my thing. AOC being a bartender is the same as I feel about Bernie Sanders dressing the way he wants to dress. I put that as a win in her column. It means she actually did something. So when people use that as a derogatory thing towards her, I don't think it makes sense. In the same way, I don't think it makes sense to say, oh, good luck as a cocktail waitress in Tampa. Like Stephen King, your elitism is showing and your sexism. Oh, by the way, Howie, I want to remind people, I'm doing this really cool thing, the mailroom manager's idea, and we're putting it together, and I'm so excited. If you guys have been wanting to go to the Fallen's Be In, I have the perfect weekend. It's the weekend of February 19th. I'm going to be there, and I cannot wait. You know, Howie, how much I love it there. I've tweeted about it a lot, talked about it a lot. Dennis is the best. He makes the best breakfast. It's just the most beautiful place to relax and walk around. I can't wait to go back. And if you guys want to join me, go to fallensbein.com. Reserve your rooms today. He has a good amount of rooms, but they're going to go fast. So make sure you get on board with that.
By the way, Grace, you know, we were playing some cuts earlier. You know, a rabbi compared him to Moses. Someone on MSNBC compared him to God. But, if you're not into that monotheistic stuff, you know, Judeo-Christian religion, you can worship fire, too. Joe Biden reminds this guy on CNN, David Chalian, of lights, kind of like fire, Zoroastrianism from Persia, those days. Listen to this, cut 37.
I mean, those lights that are just shooting out from the Lincoln Memorial along the reflecting pool, it's like almost extensions of Joe Biden's arms embracing America. It was a moment where the new president came to town and sort of convened the country in this moment of remembrance, outstretching his arms.
In a comfortable place now,
oh!
Gently close your eyes and see that there is an angel with a pitcher standing above you. And the angel now pours this pitcher over the top of your head. The light continues.
Did he do
it? What's this lady's name again?
Williamson, isn't
it? Marianne Williamson.
Yeah.
Oh, I miss her.
Didn't he? He extended his arms to Tara Reid, too, once, and she filed a complaint.
Yeah, he's gotten in trouble a lot of times for extending his arms.
Do you think David Chalian remembers any of that, or does he care? Does he think anybody else would be reminded of it if he's talking about Joe Biden extending his arms?
The other thing I'd like to say is, and if people want to check out your thank you note to President Trump, they can do that at HowieCarsher.com. But I also want to thank him because, you know, people always say like, oh, when I was a kid, you could watch the news and you didn't know which way they felt about it. They were pretty much down the middle. It's like, okay, so now they're crying. They're crying on Inauguration Day. They're saying that Joe Biden's arms remind them of lights and he's embracing the nation. I'm happy that Trump exposed these people for how non-serious they are. They're jokes. They're
Grace,
absolute jokes.
Grace, Trump, are you referring to the cruel pharaoh?
Oh, is that what we're calling Trump now?
The National Review called him the witless ape.
Witless Ape?
Their headline today was Witless Ape Rides Helicopter.
Oh, my God.
Howie,
they're on my bleep list, too. And again, I've told this story before, but I'll just tell it briefly. Before he ran for president, Donald Trump gave them Mar-a-Lago to have a fundraiser. Top of the line stuff for National Review. Rich Lowry. No good deed goes unpunished.
Oh, absolutely. Did you see today how Snoop Dogg was, you know, there was a story in the New York Post that he was really happy about some of the pardons.
Yeah.
And that he thought Trump did a really good job. And I was just thinking to myself, how many people are going to come to that realization now that it's too late and say, oh, you know, he actually wasn't that bad. Cool. Well, maybe if he had said that a year ago, we wouldn't be in this predicament.
Yeah. AJ Liebling used to say, you know, once you die, they're willing to write something nice about you now that it can't help you. But I don't think they'll ever write anything nice about Donald Trump, even in his obituaries. All right, Grace. Thank you.
Thank you, Howard. Have a good show.
Thanks. 844-500-4242. We'll take some calls in the next segment. With the incoming administration barging their way into office, this may cause some economic disturbance. Tax laws are going to change. Your tax burden on selling real estate will grow. Don't get caught flat-footed and squander the equity in your real estate. Sell today with J.J. Manning. For over 40 years, J.J. Manning has been the leading auction house in New England. From high-end homes to estates to commercial properties throughout New England, J.J. Manning can get your property sold fast and contingency-free. There's a big reason why Mass Lawyers Weekly voted J.J. Manning number one for four consecutive years. Because they have a huge following of bidders who pay cash when you sell. When you sell with a broker, you pay the commission. But in an auction, the buyer pays. These are treacherous times in the real estate market. Commercial property is way down. A lot of residential property is way up, but not in the cities. To learn more on how to get your property sold fast, contact Charlie Gill at jjmanning.com. With over 16,000 sales and satisfied clients, you can be the next one. Don't squander the equity you've built up over years or decades. Call J.J. Manning today at 800-521-0111 or go to jjmanning.com and get your property sold. I'm Howie Carr.
Howie Carr will return after this brief commercial break.
What was that headline in the National Review?
Witless Ape Rides Helicopter.
Who wrote that?
Hold on, let me find it. Was by Kevin Williamson.
Oh, that guy.
It's a callback to his 2015 column, Witless Ape Rides Escalator.
Jesus.
Common at this point that's where a big piece of this is coming from.
And they're the only friends Charlie Baker has.
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day, once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
Joe Biden accuses Trump of being a racist, but if you listen to Biden's comments, you would agree that he doth protest too much.
If you take a test where you're taking cocaine or not, what do you think, huh? Are you a junkie?
What are you, the first mainstream African-American who is articulate and bright and clean?
And Madam President, we have predators on our streets.
That kid wearing a hoodie may very well be the next poet laureate.
Have you got the Chris Wallace cut?
Gangbanger.
They are.
Yes.
Okay. Thanks.
I'd love you. You've been here all day.
And the get off my lawn cut.
Okay.
Out of society.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
I think the two-party system is good for the South and good for the Negro.
They're going to put you all back in chains.
Unlike the African-American community, with notable exceptions, the Latino community is an incredibly diverse community with incredibly different attitudes about different things.
If you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, and you ain't black.
He's the undisputed king of New England talk radio.
No brag, just fact.
Howie Carr.
I thought it was a great speech. I've been listening to these inaugural addresses since 1961. John F. Kennedy, ask not. I thought this was the best inaugural address I ever heard.
He's got to be kidding. I mean, I know, you know, he doesn't want to follow in the footsteps of what was that guy's name? Salmon and Chris Steigerwalt and get fired by Fox. But come on, Chris Wallace, the best.
It was a very forgettable speech.
It was extremely forgettable. If he had delivered that speech in Portsmouth, New Hampshire at a dealership of a local Democrat in January before the New Hampshire primary, it would have been forgettable. For an inaugural speech, it was pathetic. It was pathetic. Incidentally, Joe Biden has returned to the White House, and he invited some of his voters onto the White House lawn, and he addressed a few remarks to them, which we picked up.
Get off my lawn.
He said that? Sounds like Clint Eastwood. Lee, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Lee.
Yeah, PAGS got me too, Howie. I was trying to go without listening to a word of it. All of a sudden, I'm listening to it, and I'm like racing to the radio to shut it off. Boy, I didn't want to hear this guy at all. Oh, man. Which one of his voters brought the brown bag of doggy poop and lit it on fire?
Thanks for the call, Lee. Daniel, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Daniel.
Hey, Howie. Thanks for taking my call. On Wikipedia, it says that Joe Biden's dad, I know how Joe's saying that Jill was the first one to go to college, but Wikipedia has her dad going to business school and becoming the head of a savings and loan institution.
I think he was a car dealer too, wasn't he?
It doesn't say anything about that. It says he was in the Navy. He was a World War II vet, and then he used the GI Bill.
Yeah.
To attend business school.
He grew up even poorer than we thought. As he said today, there were holes in the ceiling when he was growing up. Apparently, cut 25 again.
I understand they worry about their jobs. I understand, like my dad, they lay in bed staring at the night, staring at the ceiling, wondering.
As I said, it was okay till it started raining. Thanks for the call, Daniel. Mr. Garcia, you're next.
Hello, how you doing, Howard Carr? I want to ask you a question. Biden break the record, everybody watching on TV? I don't think so.
Quickly.
I don't think we'll the super spreading network CNN and MSNBC will not be giving us the overnights on those ratings, because no, I don't think anybody was watching that speech either. The only ones, people like me and Daniel, that were listening to something else, and then it came on suddenly and we had no choice. I'm Howie Carr.
several years ago, we here at Matthews Brothers launched a website called MatthewsBrothers.com. We did this for a couple of reasons. First, it's our name, and it seemed to make sense that we name it after ourselves. Secondly, we thought it would be a useful place to post interesting things about our wicked awesome windows and doors. Shortly after we launched it, this fella, who insists on calling himself the webmaster, told us that he could put anything we wanted to on our website. Brand. Since we were getting kind of tired of seeing his vacation photos there, we took him up on his offer. Today, there's so much fun stuff to do on our website, it's like going to a theme park, but without the lines. Or the mask. Do you want to know the closest dealer to you? Even if you're out in the middle of nowhere? Or worse yet, New Jersey? We've got a dealer locator for that. Want to page through a colorful catalog without having to lick your fingers? We've got a flipbook for that. Accidentally take the bottom sash out of the frame and there's a blizzard coming and you can't get it back in and the factory's closed? We've even got a video for that. You can learn more about our wicked awesome windows and doors, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. Matthews Brothers with one T. America's oldest window manufacturer.
He's the gaffe that keeps on giving. Here's 1 minute of former Vice President Joe Biden.
Your teachers who touched them, figuratively speaking, I hope you touch them and tell them how much you love them too. But my point is, when you touch their hearts.
I get in trouble some of the things I say, but I want to tell you, just be straight up. If I'm your president, with me, it starts here in my gut, goes to my heart, and then I articulate it.
And by the way, you know, I sit on the stand and it get hot. I got hairy legs that turn that turn blonde in the sun. And the kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down so it was straight and then watch the hair come back up again. $1.2 billion. So you go ahead and you stack spaghetti sauce at a store in a supermarket. You control the guy or the woman who brings out the carts on a forklift. So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap, and I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
Whether it's global warming, global cooling, or climate change, one thing's for certain, the progressive moonbats can't stop talking about it.
We're talking about cities all over the world, major cities going underwater.
You know, I've spent a lot of time now with these young students, and they're scared. And a lot of young people are even suffering from, they're calling it extinction illness.
So that we can have people here who truly are committed to climate change, believe in climate change as though it's a religion, it's not a science.
A woman whose dreams of motherhood now taste bittersweet because of what I know about our children's future.
You have stolen my dreams and my childhood with your empty words.
That curing cancer is going to be much more difficult when there's so much climate change and pollutants in the environment, because a lot of cancer is environmentally caused.
Recognizing and acknowledging the link between animal agriculture and climate change is a very bold move, making tonight plant-based.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon started about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie.
Watch out, Joe Biden. You might have to share some of the spotlight because your running mate, Senator Kamala Harris, is certainly grabbing some attention for her own gaffes.
She was part of our culture. Yes, we wear those notorious B.I.G. t-shirts with a lot of pride.
Best rapper alive,
Tupac.
He's not alive. You say he lives on.
Not alive. I know. I keep doing that.
A Harris administration together with Joe Biden as the president of the United States. The Biden-Harris administration.
We have got to, in America, reimagine how we are accomplishing public safety. And let's be clear, there is no vaccine for racism.
Let's just say there is a vaccine that is approved and even distributed before the election. Would you get it?
Well, I think that's going to be an issue for all of us. I will say that I would not trust Donald Trump.
Joe Biden's plagiarizing prowess proves one thing: he's been stealing all his life.
Why is it that Joe Biden is the first in his family ever to go to a university?
Why am I the first Kinnick in a thousand generations to be able to get the university?
Why is it that my wife, who's sitting out there in the audience, is the first in her family to ever go to college?
Why is Gladys the first woman in her family in a thousand generations to be able to get the university?
No, it's not because they weren't as smart.
Does anybody really think that they didn't get what we had because they didn't have the talent?
It's not because they didn't work as hard.
Or the strength, or the endurance, or the commitment. Of course not.
It's because they didn't have a platform upon which to stand.
It was because there was no platform upon which they could stand.
I should have said, to paraphrase Neil Kinnock, it's the only time I didn't, and all the times I've ever used it.
Come on, man.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
And now, another minute of Madam Speaker Nancy Pelosi.
But, again, don't...
You have these wings, AOC and her group on one side.
That's like five people. They would say... play games, and then they'd say, open sesame, except we don't say sesame, we say open Biden. But no, I because we are not. We have no, the number is growing. We have 91 women. There are 115 women in Congress, 116, 15 are Republican, 91 are Democrats. I happen to be a manifestation of the women power that is coming forth now, but only one manifestation. It was like getting kicked in the back by a mule constantly. It was physical. It was so unbelievable. The Times found Lincoln. Not to be presumptuous to put ourselves in those categories, but the Times have found us.
Here at the Howie Carr Radio Network, we're all about saving you money. We want you to cut out the middleman and buy direct from our great sponsors. And to help you save, I've put together a cheat sheet. For instance, if you go to EdenPure.com, you'll find the Thunderstorm Air Purifier, and you can save $10 using code Howie. You can also get EdenPure's Gen 30 heater and save even more money with code Howie Deal. Do you have a dirty, dingy carpet that could use some freshening up? Head over to Genesis950.com, use code Howie, and get a gallon of their cleaner, free shipping, and other goodies with code Howie. Put a little pep in your step with Super Beats. Get more bang for your buck and do some good for your heart by going to superbeatsradio.com/Howie. While you're at it, give your ears a treat too and listen to your favorite music and podcasts with premium earbuds from Raycon. Get them at buyraycon.com/Howie. And finally, make cooking easier with HelloFresh. They'll send you easy to follow recipes and all the ingredients you need, but only if you visit HelloFresh.com/Howie. Cut out the middleman, save money, and take advantage of these deals now.
What impact do you think Russian interference had in the election?
I think it was one of the major contributors to the outcome.
Years from the 2016 election, and Hillary Clinton still can't accept the results. Take a listen.
You know, you can run the best campaign. You can be the person who gets the nomination. You could lose.
I believe he knows he's an illegitimate president. He knows.
The one thing that Trump is fearful of when it comes to his being president is that finally we will see how illegitimate his victory actually was.
This wasn't on the level.
Flashing videos that appear and then disappear and they're on the dark web and nobody can find them. It's like...
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
We'll write the next great chapter in the history of the United States of America, the American story. A story that might sound something like a song that means a lot to me.
Please, God, don't let him quote lyrics.
There's one verse that stands out, at least for me, and it goes like this.
Oh, Christ.
Muskrat Susie, Muskrat Sam, do the jitterbug out of Muskrat Land.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Just wanted to comment. I don't know if anyone else is struck by just seeing everyone masked. Even the Republicans are in masks. There's no longer that social pressure from Donald Trump.
There's no pressure. I am not myself.
I feel weak and ineffectual. I'm not Kramer.
Goodbye. We love you. Have a good life. We will see you soon.
I did it my way.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
Welcome to the Howie Carr Show, 844-500-4242. So, of course, they're trashing Trump on the way out for all manner of high crimes and misdemeanors. He issued a pardon to Judge Jeanine Pirro's ex-husband, Al Pirro. That was what the last pardon he issued. It was 45 minutes before he handed over the nuclear codes to Dementia Joe. And so they're going crazy about that. He had done time in prison for $1.2 million in illegal deductions on business expenses back 20 years ago. So he's been out of prison for a long time. It was just that, you know, some people, you know, just want the black mark off the stain off their resume. I just think it just drags up the same story. I hadn't even thought about the Al Pirro conviction for a long time. But of course, nobody ever mentions yesterday what Andrew Cuomo said. He was asked about the potential pardoning of Sheldon Silver, this crooked former speaker of the New York Assembly. He was involved in a kickback and extortion scheme that was $4 million and it involved. He's an Orthodox Jew, Sheldon Silver, Shelley Silver. He's from the Lower East Side. And so he was asked on a radio show yesterday, Cuomo, about this, whether Trump would pardon him. And Cuomo said, well, it could be a favor for someone in the Jewish community. Really? Really? What if Andrew Cuomo was a Republican and the first thing that's came to his mind when they bring up a pardon for a guy named Sheldon Silver was that he was a member of the Jewish community? Do you think he'd be in a lot of trouble? But no, of course, no one's mentioning it except for the New York Post and a couple of Jewish publications. Anyway, so everything has changed now. It's all sweetness and light. The cruel Pharaoh, as the rabbi described Donald Trump today, that is not made it. We got to keep playing this one because, again, you're not going to hear this one anywhere else or very few places. Cut 42.
This is reading from the book of Exodus about Moses is freeing us from 400 years of backbreaking Egyptian slavery at the hands of an autocratic, cruel Pharaoh. In many ways, dear Joe, you are our Moses.
An autocratic, cruel Pharaoh. King Tut. King Tut. Well, I'll tell you another thing that's changed. You know, 400,000 people have now died from COVID-19 in the United States of America. And if Trump had been inaugurated for a second term today, you know the words they would have used, Taylor? Crossing.
Another grim milestone.
Yes. Grim milestone. But there are no more grim milestones today now that the cruel Pharaoh has passed from the scene. Here are some headlines from the left-wing media on the $400,000 milestone. New York Times passes $400,000. Vox exceeds. ABC News eclipses. Washington Post toll reaches. CNN surpasses. And NBC, my favorite, Joe Biden consoles nation. He consoles nation. Yes. 844-500-4242. I want to, you know, I know people are down. People may be down a little bit today. And I want to read a poem that's it's a way to kind of keep a stiff upper lip. And it's by a guy who always kept a stiff upper lip. And that would be Rudyard Kipling. And he actually said he got tired of having this poem in every anthology of modern British poetry. But there's a reason why it's in all these anthologies. And it's called If. I'm just going to read you a few lines. And it tells you how to handle these kinds of situations where you're disappointed and you feel like you've lost something and you know, you may be headed for a dark winter, to coin a phrase. This is If by Rudyard Kipling. If you can keep your head when all about you are losing theirs and blaming it on you, if you can trust yourself when all men doubt you, but make allowance for their doubting too, if you can bear to hear the truth you've spoken twisted by knaves to make a trap for fools, or watch the things you gave your life to broken, and stoop and build them up with worn out tools. If you can force your heart and nerve and sinew to serve your turn long after they are gone, and so hold on when there is nothing in you except the will which says to them, hold on. If you can talk with crowds and keep your virtue, or walk with kings, nor lose the common touch, if neither foes nor loving friends can hurt you, if all men count with you, but none too much, if you can fill the unforgiving minute with 60 seconds worth of distance run, yours is the earth and everything that's in it, and, which is more, you'll be a man, my son. So just remember that, you know, whatever, just keep pushing ahead, no matter how you feel. That's my fatherly advice for everybody today. 844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. Let's play some more of this nastiness from the mainstream media here. Wolf Blitzer, cut 35.
We can hear that Marine one flying just over our heads, not too far away at all, but should be landing Joint Base Andrews. It's what a difference 4 years makes. He had a very impressive, huge crowd at his inauguration. It's going to be a little pathetic, a tiny little crowd at Joint Base Andrews, where he's going to say goodbye.
Wait a second. 4 years ago, they were saying he didn't have a big crowd, right? And now that it's clear that they had to paper Biden's inauguration with all those 200,000 flags, now he had a very impressive crowd, and today's crowd was very pathetic. Has he seen any videotape of the people lining the roads and the streets from when he landed at the PBI West Palm Beach International Airport, all the way back to Mar-a-Lago? Has Wolf seen any of that? And then this is CNN's Dana Bash. Cut 36.
He just looks like a small man. And that is exactly the way that he has handled his presidency since he lost. And he just has appeared smaller and smaller and less courageous.
Oh, wow. Yeah. And now they're giggling as the plane takes off, as Air Force One takes off. Cut 36.
Air Force One takes off. And the Trump family leaves Washington, leaves the seat of power.
Yes, it was my way.
There you go. These are the same people who are now saying that Biden's inaugural address, which was below average at best, is the greatest thing since JFK in 1961, after Robert Frost read the poem.
They couldn't even let him have that nice send-off, like that nice moment. They had to stomp all over it and make fun of it as the guy's on his way out. Just, you can't give him that one moment. Yeah, it's a hackneyed song, but
yeah,
it was a nice view. The plane literally lifted off the ground, as Sinatra said, "It was my way." It was beautiful.
I know
they couldn't let him have it. Those are the small people.
I know, and you know, now that the cruel pharaoh is gone, who are they gonna have to kick around? You know, as Nixon said, you won't have Nixon to kick around anymore. 844-500-4242. Hit refresh on your dinner routine in 2021 with HelloFresh. Right now, you could take advantage of their limited time New Year's sale and see why HelloFresh is America's number one meal kit. You often get into ruts in all aspects of your daily routine, and meals is one of them. You cook the same food week after week, weekend after weekend, and you go to those same aisles, buy the same products. HelloFresh is a way to get out of that rut. It gives you simple recipes and fresh ingredients sourced directly from growers and delivered to your door contact-free. With more than 23 weekly recipes, there's something for everyone to enjoy, including family-friendly, vegetarian, and low-calorie options. Say goodbye to never-ending meal planning and prepping. HelloFresh recipe cards are easy to follow with simple steps and pictures. Grace and Taylor and I have all done the HelloFresh meals, and we agree it's a great thing.
So smooth, so easy to go through. And again, with Biden in the White House now, watch transportation prices go up with the prices of gas. The food in the grocery store is going way up. So this is probably a cost-saving method that is your best option, HelloFresh.
And you don't have to put up with the BS of all the mask madness and all that stuff that you're going to get. And the Karens roaming up and down the aisles to make sure everyone is obeying the rules of the cruel Pharaoh. You can get meals on the table in as little as 20 minutes. Plus, by skipping the grocery store, you can save up to 40% on groceries, cut food waste by 25%, and save time so you have more time to spend with your loved ones. Go to HelloFresh.com and use code Howie10 for 10 free meals across 4 boxes, including free shipping on your first box, during HelloFresh's New Year's sale. For a limited time only, go to HelloFresh.com and use code Howie10 for 10 free meals. HelloFresh.com. I'm Howie Carr.
If you change the station, the moon bats win. You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
He's the co-sponsor of the Green New Deal, so what better time to play some of his greatest hits? Ladies and gentlemen, it's Mr. Frosty.
This is going to be a mission to save all of creation.
If you want to ignore that these changes are taking place and that they're having a dramatic impact, then you are in the right place.
You know what the winters were like at Plymouth Rock? You know what the winters were like at Plymouth Rock, Senator?
Well, here is the thing.
You don't. How long has your family been in Massachusetts?
We are new arrivals. And
Mr. President, American history was made last night. The Boston Patriots won the Super Bowl.
When the Second Amendment was written in order to maintain a well-regulated militia, they did not have in mind that people could purchase guns indiscriminately.
The president is acting like Pontius Pilate.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. Thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is
some calls
number
here.
One. Taylor. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great. I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now, when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair. For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie. What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out? Get the hair you've always wanted. Hairman.com/Howie.
I want to be clear in how I characterize this. This is mostly a protest. It is not, generally speaking, unruly.
That ain't a riot, what we're seeing right now in Minneapolis.
They are strictly principled anti-fascists.
No organization is perfect. There was some violence.
Any reasonable person would say we shouldn't be destroying other people's property, but these are not reasonable times.
I argue to you tonight, all punches are not equal morally.
But thank goodness for the looters, man.
And please, show me where it says that protests are supposed to be polite and peaceful.
Do not get it twisted and think that, oh, this is something that has never happened before, and then this is so terrible, and where are we, and these savages, and all of that. This is how this country was started.
People get mad, and people get sick of it. People are risking COVID to explain to this country that we're fed up.
Burning down the house.
about you? What have you heard, Shane?
I've heard that you're a low-down Yankee liar.
Howie Carr is back.
New year, new hobbies, and everything is better with Raycon wireless earbuds. With up to 6 hours of playtime, water and sweat-resistant construction, and seamless Bluetooth pairing, you can take Raycon's premium audio anywhere you go. Right now, get 15% off at buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Will Joe Biden last his whole term?
No, obviously not.
Only 4% say yes, he will.
They're making sport of us by saying that he will. No one really believes he'll cover the whole term. Incidentally, Politico is no longer covering up Biden's cognitive decline. I don't know if you saw this. They talked about how this is an anecdote, you know, about how Biden prepares for speeches. For higher profile remarks, Biden would obsessively rehearse portions until he committed them to memory. That's scary. Because given his memory, and at times through the various iterations of outlining remarks, Biden could grow downright ornery. I would never say this, Biden once snapped at an aide, aghast over the prepared remarks he was reviewing, according to a person in the room during a prep session last year. Where did you get this from? The aide explained that Biden had said it himself at a public speech a couple of weeks earlier. Okay. So now it's safe. Now we have to prepare the way for the 25th Amendment, you know, for President Kamala Harris. So we can start talking about it. Before it was practically hate speech to mention this kind of stuff. I was accused of it when I would write my columns during the campaign of his stumbles, shall we say. Amanda, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Amanda.
Hey, Howie. Long time, first time.
Thank you. Excited. Thank you.
I just wanted to call and say that I know that we're all saying, like, who is the media going to talk about now that Trump's gone? But we all know when you leave your job, you are literally blamed for the next 6 months while you're not there.
Right.
So I think we're going to keep hearing. This is, you know, hey, this was, you know, look what we discovered.
Right. You know, Amanda, I'll give you the phrase they're going to use, a variation thereof. We inherited a real mess. We had no idea how bad it was until we got in here. I think that's what Clinton's people said when they came in 93. You know, the economy was already recovering, but they had no idea how bad it was. That's why Clinton couldn't give the middle class the tax cut that he had promised out on the campaign trail. I tried harder than anything I ever done, but there's just, I couldn't do it. I couldn't do it. Come over here, Monica. Give me a slice of pizza. Thanks, Amanda. Kathy, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Kathy.
Hi. Hi there. Longtime fan.
Thank you.
I wanted to say I'm super bummed out today. There isn't a bigger Trump supporter. I've gone to rallies. I went to the December 12th rally, and then when he said he'd be there at the January 6th, I went right back. And I walked by the Capitol building, and I saw people there, but you know what was really weird is there was no security.
Yeah.
I believe the whole thing was a setup.
I know. A lot of people are saying, you know who's in charge of security at the Capitol, Kathy? Nancy Pelosi. I mean, ultimately, it's her responsibility. What the hell was going on? Where was she? And again, I keep coming back to this because it's a story you're never going to see on the slobber fests about Joe Biden and Kamala Harris tonight. But this is in the Washington Post today. Now that it doesn't matter anymore, this is the headline. Self-styled militia members plan to storm Capitol days before attack, court documents say. So in other words, it was not an incitement to insurrection, that speech. There's even emails in these court documents saying you can recognize us. We'll be wearing our MAGA hats backward. That's how you can tell who we are. And no one's reporting this. Just like, they had to, they're very concerned, that these National Guards, 26,000 of them, are going to turn on the Democrats because they're all white and they're all male. So they must be. So then the FBI is leaking, you know, the corrupt FBI is leaking this stuff, saying that they're picking up chatter that there's going to be an uprising. And so then it turns out the DOD, Department of Defense, says there is no such uprising. There's no such chatter. There's nothing here. And nothing to see here, folks. Move along. Move along. It's a, you know, the front page story in the Washington Post just disappears down the black hole of forgotten Trump lies. That was probably the last big lie of the Trump 4 years, the last lie of how many thousands or hundreds of thousands. 844-500-4242. And remember, Trump has no crowds at his inauguration. Today they're saying, remember how big his crowds were 4 years ago? Now when he's leaving, nobody's there. It was an Air Force base, right? He left from the White House grounds to an Air Force base.
And Howie, what would they have said if he had large crowds at the Air Force
base? It's a super spreader.
Exactly.
Yeah. It's a super spreader. Garth Brooks shook hands with everybody after he sang his song. I didn't think you were supposed to be shaking hands. And incidentally, is Garth Brooks going to be canceled by his predominantly Trump-loving Republican audiences? Is anyone hate-tweeting at Garth Brooks this afternoon? Amongst the deplorables and the credulous boomer rubes? I think not. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
As this year of COVID draws to a close, it's time to make sure your portfolio is ready for whatever happens next. Kevin Frisbee and the team at Frisbee & Associates are ready to help you. It's called the 100-100 Challenge. If you have $100,000 saved for retirement and come in for that no-cost, no-obligation consultation, you'll walk out with $100 cash. That's right, $100 just to let Kevin do a portfolio x-ray and see what might be hiding in your current plan. Call now for your no-cost or obligation consultation, and you could walk out with $100 cash. Call 800-989-9100. That's 800-989-9100. Kevin is a true fiduciary. That means by law, he's always working in your best interest. And be sure and catch Kevin on the Howie Carr radio program every Thursday afternoon for a market review and tips on creating the retirement of your dreams. Call Kevin Frisbee today, 800-989-9100. That's 800-989-9100.
And now, a minute of wisdom from Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
Millennials and people and, you know, Gen Z and all these folks that come after us are looking up and we're like, the world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change. And your biggest issue is your biggest issue is how are we going to pay for it? And like, this is the war. This is our World War II.
I think that there's a lot of people more concerned about being precisely, factually, and semantically correct than about being morally right.
But being factually correct is important.
It's absolutely important.
And if we work our butts off to make sure that we take back all three chambers of government, the presidency, the Senate, and the House in 2020, we can't start working in 2020.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300. I've seen a lot of Anchor cupcakes in my day. Here are some of the latest network nitwits.
Tenney says, if I'm elected president, I will push for a constitutional amendment to impose term limits on all members of Congress. Correct me, there already are term limits, so what does he mean?
And what are we hearing in the background? Is that shelling?
No, Katie, you're actually hearing that here in Jerusalem, and okay. It's actually fireworks going off right behind me.
We're in our tribes, we're in our corners most of our lives. I think we just heard some gunshots. Should we listen to that for a second? Control room? Not gunshots? Okay. Ivanka is not the second lady. She is actually, I don't think she deserves this position. She's actually a senior advisor to the president. So the idea that he would demean her specifically in that way, he shouldn't talk about the first lady that way. We aren't all here to make salads for men. It's disgusting.
I mean, I'm presuming he was talking about Karen Pence when he said second lady.
Oh,
I
don't, God, I'm sorry.
Not Montana. I'm talking about never mind.
Yeah, no,
I was getting Montana and North Dakota confused because, I don't know, I just was.
When you're in the house for longer periods of time, you can see them flying or running across the floor. Ooh, yuck. They're unhealthy, gross, and disgusting. Bugs. I loathe bugs. We keep a clean home, but occasionally bugs show up. Well, I found something that is tougher than bugs. Orange Guard. On contact, it kills hidden bugs, including ants, roaches, and fleas. Plus, Orange Guard is a residual repellent. All of the ingredients of Orange Guard are on the FDA generally recognized as safe list. Orange Guard may be used around food, humans, and pets. It comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Orange Guard, available at orangeguard.com, Whole Foods, and Ace Hardware.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. That's the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. You know, one of my favorite blogs is powerlineblog.com, and they have a bunch of really astute observers. I think they're all lawyers from Minneapolis, or used to live in Minneapolis. Some of them still do. And John Heinderacker wrote a great column yesterday, Après Trump, the deluge, meaning Louis XIV. He said, after me, the deluge. And John was talking about the immigration, open borders that is being promised here. And John, I'm so glad to see people picking up on this. I've written about it in my own columns in the Boston Herald, and we've talked about it on the air. But I mean, this is one of the most important accomplishments of the Trump years, I think, is getting the borders back under control with the travel ban and with the southern border being under control. And Biden says on his first day, he's going to repeal both of those measures.
Well, that's right. He had 17 executive orders slated to be issued today. And one of them is to halt all construction on the border wall. He's got an amnesty plan that he's put out there. Under which anybody who can show that he was in the country illegally as of January 1st is golden and will be given amnesty and put on a path to citizenship. And Howie, the path to citizenship, even if you get a green card, is, you know, has been 5 years, but under the Biden plan, they're accelerating that to 3 years.
And gee, what a coincidence, huh?
What a coincidence.
3 years will be, that will be a leap year. And what do we do in leap years? We have, presidential elections.
Just in time for the 2024 election, millions of votes from what are now illegal immigrants will be delivered. If Biden's plan, of course, becomes law.
And as you pointed out, too, in 1986, and Reagan always said the amnesty in 1986 was the biggest mistake of his presidency. And I think there's no question about it. But they were supposed to, again, only grandfather people in who'd been there, but everybody came up with these fake documents. And they can get the you know, Puerto Rican driver's licenses, birth certificates. We see it in Massachusetts all the time. We write about it all the time. I mean, all they're going to need in this case is going to be a utility bill, or maybe even not even a utility bill.
Most, Howie, and it's not like this is a big hurdle to get over. They just got to have some evidence that they were in the country as of January 1st, 2021. I mean, not exactly ancient history. I'm sure we'll bring the same careful security measures that we bring to our voting system to vet these folks.
You know, the other thing too, if you listen to what Biden was saying today, and I don't blame anyone who didn't listen. I just happened into it, but he's talking about we have to get Americans back to work. Yet on the other hand, he's also saying we're going to open the borders to all these people who have absolutely no skills, many of whom don't even want to work, but they're going to compete against all these unemployed Americans. And then he also says we're going to have to do something about COVID-19, but we're going to let in all these people who aren't wearing, they're coming up through Mexico on these caravans, which I call gravy trains. They're not wearing masks. These countries south of the border have a much higher rate of testing positive than we do. And so we're going to have, some Democrats want mandatory vaccinations. They want to keep the mask going forever, but they're going to let in all these illegal aliens that aren't wearing masks and are testing positive. How does this make any sense, John?
Howie, it doesn't. None of this makes any sense. Biden says we have to put Americans back to work. Well, guess what? Donald Trump did that. We have the lowest unemployment,
right,
the highest employment, especially for middle class and blue collar folks. We had rising wages. Of course, Biden wants to do the exact opposite of everything that Trump did that did succeed in putting Americans back to work. And on top of that, you know, on top of the all the terrible economic policies, $15 minimum wage, for example, you know, make it illegal for anybody to work if he can't deliver $15 an hour plus, you know, in benefit to his employer. So all of these things, as you say, they're all designed to unemploy more Americans. And if you really want to put Americans back to work, end the COVID shutdowns.
Yeah, I'm glad you brought up the minimum wage thing. I was going to get into that later in the day, but right now, John, you know this. You've done the reading. Right now, the national minimum wage for tipped workers is $2.13 an hour, $2.13 an hour, and that's because you make it up in tips. When I used to work as a tipped employee in Maine many years ago, it was 55 cents an hour. So that's how old I am. But so Joe Biden wants to raise the minimum wage from $2.13 an hour for tipped workers to $15 an hour. Do you think that's going to increase or decrease employment among tipped employees across the nation, John?
You know, these poor restaurants and bars, they get shut down, then they're allowed to partly reopen, then they're shut down again, then maybe partly reopen. There are, you know, thousands and thousands have gone out of business. And now it's, well, the good news is at some point here you get to reopen. The bad news is you can't possibly make any money.
And I'm reading now from a column in the Wall Street Journal. Mr. Biden in the second debate told Donald Trump, there's no evidence that when you raise the minimum wage, businesses go out of business. I guess he's never seen any stories, or maybe he's never visited San Francisco or Seattle, all those places on the West Coast that raised the minimum wage and destroyed all these mom and pop restaurants, not to mention independent bookstores and all other kinds of small businesses.
Howie, the laws of supply and demand have not been repealed, and there's no topic in the field of economics that has been studied more thoroughly than the baleful impacts of high minimum wage laws. You know, if you keep the minimum wage below what's actually starting salaries for unskilled employees, you know, teenagers in the workplace, it doesn't do any harm. But as soon as you raise it above that, you start unemploying people. And you start, you know, people start replacing employees with kiosks and you know, all the things that employers do to try to manage their costs. And ultimately, if they can't work around that kind of an extravagant minimum wage, they wind up going out of business.
But as we know, a lot of the unions base their wages. It's in the contract that they get, like, if the minimum wage is, they get two times the minimum wage. right? So this is a sop to unions, both in the public and the private sector, although the unions now are predominantly public sector, you know? So this is another payoff for union money.
Yeah, that's right. As the Democrats always do, they screw young people, especially minorities, to benefit their big source of money, which is the public sector unions.
So you got a column coming out today. I don't think it's posted yet. You're going to give us an assessment, your assessment of Trump's years. And I wrote him a thank you note. I thanked him for a bunch of things in the Boston Herald. Rush read some of it today. I think it was a tremendous success, and I think you think it was more of a success than even some of your fellow scribes at powerlineblog.com.
You know, Howie, I published that post about 20 minutes ago, and the title of it is Trump Fought the Swamp and the Swamp Won. Oh. You're old enough, Howie, to remember that song.
I sure am.
I fought the-
Yeah, we used to play that song whenever a Massachusetts House Speaker would be convicted of a felony. It got a lot of play for Bobby Fuller Four. We gave him a lot of royalties over the years.
Right. Bobby Fuller. I fought the law. The law won. Trump fought the swamp and the swamp won. What I say in the post, Howie, is that in my opinion, Trump was pretty easily our best president since Ronald Reagan. And I walk through his various accomplishments, and you know them all. You've recited the list many times, yeah. Both domestic policy and foreign policy, just like Reagan. Huge successes in both spheres. And yet, whereas Reagan carried 49 states when he ran for re-election, Trump was unable to get a second term. And that's partly due to COVID. Obviously, I think if it hadn't been for COVID, he would have gotten re-elected. And it certainly is partly due to the incredible, unremitting hate that he got from the swamp, you know, from the establishment, including, you know, number one on the list, the Russia collusion hoax, perpetrated by Hillary Clinton, picked up by the FBI, institutionalized in the form of a special counsel. I mean, we've never seen anything like it. You know, the two comic opera impeachments by the Democrats. And yet, you know, Trump, too, was hated and reviled by the liberals. I thought when Trump when did I say that wrong? Reagan was hated, too. When Reagan left office, I thought we would never again see hate like that directed at a president. Well, we didn't until Donald Trump came along. And so, but the point I make, in the end, I give Trump a B+. I think he was a very, very good president, as I say, best since Reagan. But I think in the end, you know, he was brought down in part by his own defects of character and personality. And I think part of the reason why the haters couldn't destroy Reagan was his character, you know, his equanimity, his obvious reasonableness, you know, his fairness. In the end, I think voters realized Reagan was just a better man, you know, than the people that were trying to destroy him. And I think a lot of voters didn't conclude that about Donald Trump. Now, I don't agree with him, you know, but I think that his personality made him vulnerable. And in the end, the swamp won.
But Trump was part of the, he was one of the beautiful people for all those years. They loved him. He'd go on Howard Stern, you know, who's become a beautiful person himself. And Ronald Reagan, I don't think he never believed he was part of the gang, right? I mean, they kicked Donald Trump down the stairs. Well, look at the Access Hollywood tape. They sat on that thing for 11 years until right before the election.
Right.
And then they tried to stab him in the back with it.
Yeah, sure.
I don't blame him for what I'm getting at, John, is I don't blame him for being angrier than Ronald Reagan was.
I don't blame him either. That's the thing. And a lot of people say, and I've said it myself, if he hadn't been combative, if he hadn't been willing to fight, you know, fight the press, he never would have gotten where he did. And
right.
That's true. But there's more to it, I'm afraid. You know, he was wrong too often. He made too many mistakes. And he came across to too many voters as belligerent and egomaniacal. And I, you know, and in the end, there were too many voters who were willing to overlook his great accomplishments because they couldn't get past his personality. Now, I don't agree with that. Look, I voted for him enthusiastically twice. you know, but nevertheless, the fact is that instead of seeing Donald Trump looking out at the prospect of another successful term in office, and think how much good he could have done in the last 4 years. You know, a two-term president.
I mean, just keeping his fingers in all these dikes, you know, like immigration and the Green New Deal and increasing taxes. I mean, he just would have kept the lid on this insanity that's now going to be unleashed.
And a two-term president can accomplish three times as much as a one-term president. You know, that's how it works. There's a huge startup, you know, involved there. So we missed out on that. You know, we're missing out on a Trump second term. And, you know, I think that's kind of tragic. And I think that some of it has to do with Trump's own failings. So in the end, I gave him a B+, best president since Reagan by far. And yet here we are looking at Joe Biden as our president.
Oh, I look forward to reading your column. You saw what the National Review said about him. They have a story running on their website. Witless ape rides helicopter. Can you believe that?
Oh, God. How did that happen, Howie? How did that happen? The flagship publication of the right for all those years just drove, you know, off the dock and into the bay.
I don't get it. I can't take them anymore than I can take Fox, you know? I mean, witless ape. Are they happy now?
I understand the Democrats, right? They're in it for money and power. I understand. I can get that, right?
Yeah.
I don't understand the never Trumpers who call themselves conservatives, call themselves Republicans, and stab him in the back. And well, congratulations, you know, Joe Biden is now our president.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Sin in haste, repent at leisure. It's an old saying.
See how much leisure we have. Hey, Howie, to be macabre for a moment, what's the over-under on Joe Biden? How long is he going to serve as
president? Well, that's our poll question today. 96% don't think he's going to make it to 2025. I don't think he's going to make it 2 years. Do you?
Well, that's the question. That's the over-under. He's not making it to 2025. I'm with the 96%. But, you know, how close does he come? I don't know.
All right. John Heineracker, thanks for being with us. We appreciate it. And again, if you want, it's great reading every day, powerlineblog.com. Thank you, John. We're all looking for ways to save money, right? Especially now. So let me ask you this. How'd you like to keep an extra $961 a year in your pocket? That's how much Gabby customers save per year on average on car and home insurance. That's why when I was shopping for insurance, I used Gabby. This is the time of year we go shopping for insurance. Well, Gabby takes the pain out of shopping for insurance by giving you an apples-to-apples comparison of your current coverage with 40 of the top insurance providers like Progressive, Nationwide, and Travelers. Just link your current insurance account, and in just minutes, you'll be able to see quotes for the exact same coverage that you currently have. That's what I did. It's fast. It was very easy to use, and I'm not very computer savvy. I was with my old insurance company, car insurance company, for more than 20 years. And, you know, I just paid the premium every year when it would come. I never looked for anything new. I never realized that there were these changes that would have saved me money. I just kept overpaying year after year. It was laziness. I logged in with my current insurance. I was shown dozens of quotes, and I think Gabby ended up saving me over $500 just on my car insurance alone. I should have done it years earlier. As I mentioned earlier, on average, Gabby customers save $961 per year. I bet that'd be nice to have in your pocket every year. If they can't find you savings like they did for me, they'll let you know so you can relax knowing you have the best rate out there. And they'll never sell your info, so no annoying spam or robocalls. You're probably overpaying on car and home insurance. See how much Gabby can save you. It's totally free to check, and there's no obligation. Go to Gabby.com/Howie. That's Gabi.com/Howie. Gabi.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
He's the maestro of microaggression. He's Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by J.T. Kelly, real estate broker at Keller Williams, who helped my daughter find a house. The 2021 housing market is already on fire. Contact him at
1-800-800-800.
364-9200.
You can open up the lines.
And now, 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
It is a bill that is much needed for our farmers and ranchers. I think there are only 47 votes against it in the House of Representatives. The American people should know the source of it. Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure. No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable. And I talked to Chuck last night to say, you know, we haven't had an answer. There are other things that are going on that are newsworthy. And I think I think you'd have more viewers or readers if people address concerns that people have. The list goes on about the
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day, once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie.
What does the mainstream media really think of you? Banjos, please.
Bigots and racists. Credulous, rude, ten-toothed,
working class, angry, white.
Aging, angry, white guys.
Angry, white man.
Angry, white old man.
These angry white men.
The angry white vote.
All these angry white people.
Too many of them want to see the people who are begging for change put down.
Racist. Racist, bigoted base.
It's white privilege, it's white nationalism, it's anger, it's rage, it's insult.
It tolerated a certain level of racism.
One in three Americans are racist.
The credulous boomer rube demo.
Y'all elitist for them.
you elitist with your geography and your maps and your spelling. Even though my
math, you're reading.
Yeah, you're reading.
They're too far gone.
Look at them. They're high-fiving each other, and they're going to go back, you know, to the Olive Garden and to the Holiday Inn that they're staying at and the Garden Marriott, and they're going to have some drinks.
He's the smartest guy in the room.
I think Papa has it all figured out. Figured out and wrapped up in tissue paper with pink ribbons on it.
Howie Carr is back.
You want more insanity from Biden? He's talking about the need to get Americans back to work. And he's talking about the need to build bridges to our allies and not needlessly offend them. So one of these 17 executive orders that he's supposedly signing as we speak ends the permitting for the Keystone XL pipeline. And the Keystone XL pipeline brings crude oil down from Canada into the U.S. to get connected to the pipelines down to the Gulf refineries. And those are very good paying jobs. Good jobs and good wages, as Mike Dukakis used to say. And when they end that, it's going to be a lot harder for Canada to get the oil to the refineries. So it's going to put lots, if he can pull it off, and there's questions about whether or not this is actually a legal maneuver that he's attempting here. And it's just a sop to the Green New Deal people. He's going to irritate Canada and the Western provinces, especially where the oil comes from. And he's going to irritate all the workers on that pipeline. Have there been? But it's going to make Warren Buffett happy, because before the pipeline, they used to carry the oil in tankers. Tankers on his railroad lines. You may remember there were some pretty horrible ecological disasters when the trains would overturn the tankers. I'm Howie Carr.
Listen up. This is the best deal you're going to be offered all week. Have you been thinking about buying one of the Eden Pure Gen 30 space heaters or the Thunderstorm air purifier? Well, until Friday, you don't have to buy one or the other. You can get both. With code word thunder, you will get a free thunderstorm when you purchase the Gen 30 space heater. Home heating bills are about to start skyrocketing, potentially costing you hundreds of dollars a month. Eden Pure Gen 30 heater will save you up to 50% on your heating bills. The Eden Pure Gen 30 Classic Infrared Heater uses state-of-the-art infrared heat to warm you to the core. It's even been proven to keep you warmer than your furnace and save you money on your heating bills every month. Go to EdenPure.com and put in code word thunder. That's nearly a $100 savings, and shipping is free too. Buy the Eden Pure Gen 30 and with code word thunder, you get a free Thunderstorm air purifier. EdenPure.com. You'll never be cold again, and you'll never smell that odor again. EdenPure.com, code word thunder.
President Trump is clearly ethically unfit and intellectually unprepared to be the president of the United States.
And I salute Chairman in the coming weeks, the House will hold hearings. Congresswoman Harris, Senator Harris.
He's our president, and I would rather he not be taking something that has not been approved, especially in his age group and in his, shall we say, weight group, what is morbidly obese, they say.
So completely inappropriate in so many ways that it's almost a given. It's like a child who comes in with mud on their pants or something. That's the way it is. They're outside playing. That's what it is. He comes in with doggy doo on his shoes, and everybody who works with him has that on their shoes too. But I only will do that if you tell me that this legislation is worthy of George Kirby's name.
This movement of moment of national anguish.
This is Charlie Baker.
Hey, everybody. Massachusetts Governor Charlie Baker here.
And these are his friends.
I may not make it through this story. And I told a story about a fisherman that I met in New Bedford. He's coming off the boat. He's a big, huge man, completely soaked in sweat and salt water.
In the world of Charlie Baker and his friends, the real world of panic porn, political leaders cannot survive without absolute power. And the public can't be expected to blindly follow orders without first hearing a made-up story.
And he started to cry, and I gave him a hug. He was a big, huge guy. It was like hugging a mountain. And then he said, "See those two kids up there?" And he said, "Those are my sons." They were both spectacular football players at New Bedford High School who were given college scholarships, and it ruined their lives. And you hear those kinds of stories every day.
And they are the only friends Charlie Baker has.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon start at about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable noise-isolating fit. Perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie.
Joe Biden's plagiarizing prowess proves one thing. He's been stealing all his life.
Let us pledge that our generation of Americans
will pay any price.
We shall pay any price.
Bear any burden.
Bear any burden.
Accept any challenge and meet any hardship.
Meet any hardship.
To secure the blessings of prosperity and the promise of opportunity for our children.
To assure the survival and the success of liberty.
But this standard is not a measure of how we can evaluate the condition of our society. We cannot measure the health of our children.
Yet the gross national product does not allow for the health of our children.
The quality of our education.
The quality of their education.
The joy of their play.
For the joy of their play.
Come on, man.
Are we starting to feel bad for Joe Biden? Sorta. Are we going to play his gaffes anyway? Of course.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate for the United States Senate.
Now we need to stand behind Jamie Harrison, the next president of the United States Senate.
I'm looking forward to appointing the first African-American woman to the United States Senate.
Just like here in California, I mean, here in Nevada.
Back in the spring, late fall, late spring, late winter, early fall, anyway, you know what I mean.
Look, tomorrow's Superstar Tuesday.
I tell you what, I'm rushing ahead, aren't I?
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by the, go, you know the thing.
He says you cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
We'll see who's sleepy.
Mr. Vice President, thank you.
All right, Chuck, thank you very much.
All right, it's Chris.
Sometimes I wake up and I think it's 1920, not 2020.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
I'm the Vice President of the United States.
Love him or hate him, Joe Biden's here for the long haul. But we can't get enough of his gaffes. Here's the best of Uncle Joe speaking before he thinks.
We choose truth over facts.
When the stock market crashed, Franklin Rosenblatt got on television.
Make sure you have the record player on at night.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
Okay, all right. Well, you can crap with me later, okay?
The teachers are recon. I'm married to a teacher. My deceased wife is a teacher.
And Corn Pop was a bad dude.
I can tell you, and I've known 8 presidents, 3 of the minimum.
If you agree with me, go to Joe 30330 and help me.
Had over 40 kids shot at Kent State on a beautiful lawn.
I love this place. Look, what's not to like about Vermont in terms of the beauty of it? I said something that was not meant the way I said.
I mean, what is it that I said wrong?
I want to be clear. I'm not going nuts. Anyway, my time's up. I'm sorry.
Here at the Howie Carr Radio Network, we're all about saving you money. We want you to cut out the middleman and buy direct from our great sponsors. And to help you save, I've put together a cheat sheet. For instance, if you go to EdenPure.com, you'll find the Thunderstorm Air Purifier, and you can save $10 using code Howie. You can also get EdenPure's Gen 30 heater and save even more money with code Howie Deal. Do you have a dirty, dingy carpet that could use some freshening up? Head over to Genesis950.com, use code Howie, and get a gallon of their cleaner, free shipping, and other goodies with code Howie. Put a little pep in your step with Super Beats. Get more bang for your buck and do some good for your heart by going to superbeatsradio.com/Howie. While you're at it, give your ears a treat too and listen to your favorite music and podcasts with premium earbuds from Raycon. Get them at buyraycon.com/Howie. And finally, make cooking easier with HelloFresh. They'll send you easy to follow recipes and all the ingredients you need, but only if you visit HelloFresh.com/Howie. Cut out the middleman, save money, and take advantage of these deals now.
He is the youngest senator that is going to be running. In his video, he also mentioned he's the only senator that lives in the inner city, and he's an unmarried vegan. So a lot of very unique qualities Cory Booker brings to the table, Kate.
Now, I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is about the closest I'll probably ever have in my life to an I am Spartacus moment. I am Spartacus. I am Spartacus.
Joey, you like movies about gladiators?
Have you ever had an LGBTQ law clerk?
I've not been a judge, so I don't have any law clerks.
Someone working for you?
I'm to be honest, I don't know the sexual orientation of my...
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
We'll write the next great chapter in the history of the United States of America, the American story. A story that might sound something like a song that means a lot to me.
Please, God, don't let him quote lyrics.
There's one verse that stands out, at least for me, and it goes like this.
Oh, Christ.
Muskrat Susie, Muskrat Sam, do the jitterbug out of Muskrat Land.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Just wanted to comment. I don't know if anyone else is struck by just seeing everyone masked. Even the Republicans are in masks. There's no longer that social pressure from Donald Trump.
There's no pressure. I am not myself. I feel weak and ineffectual. I'm not Kramer.
Goodbye. We love you. Have a good life. We will see you soon.
I did it my way.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
Texter 917 asked, did you ever think you'd live to see Americans elect a complete imbecile? Well, H.L. Mencken did, the sage of Baltimore. I got a bunch of his quotes today I'll be reading, but here's one. As democracy is perfected, the office of the president represents more and more closely the inner soul of the people. We move toward a lofty ideal. On some great and glorious day, the plain folks of the land will reach their heart's desire at last, and the White House will be adorned by a downright moron. That day would be January 20th, 2021. We have reached the pinnacle, or the nadir, as it were. 844-500-4242. I'm looking at the headlines here. Feds quietly close Flynn leak investigation, find no wrongdoing by crooked Obama officials. This was when the Obama officials leaked General Flynn's conversation with the Russian ambassador, which was totally legal, by the way, to the Washington Post. And that was totally illegal. But they've closed the investigation. Nothing to see here, folks. Move along. You remember Senator Richard Burr, the swamp creature from North Carolina, from Winston-Salem? He's not running for re-election because he couldn't be re-elected in North Carolina. He was investigated for insider trading after he got a briefing on COVID-19 and then adjusted his stock portfolio more than somewhat. He bought medical stocks, unloaded other stocks. They were investigating him. The investigation has now been closed. What a coincidence. What happened? Why does the investigation been closed? How much time do you think Kevin Kleinsmith, the crooked FBI lawyer who changed the memo from the CIA to make Carter Page look like a spy, he's up for sentencing next week. You think he's going to do any time? Nah. How about Shelley Joseph, the judge in the district court judge in Newton, who was indicted for letting the illegal alien career criminal drug dealer go out the back door when the ICE agents were waiting? She's still under indictment as of today. How long do you think till the charges are dropped? Probably by the end of the week. Yeah, I think so. In the halls of justice, the only justice is in the halls. Time now for the chump line.
I think we should work with Joe Biden, just like the Democrats did with President Trump.
Right. Exactly. One of the texters says he thinks Joe Biden will make it to 2025, as in 8:25 p.m. tonight.
We now live in a Bidenocracy with no democracy, thanks to Pelosi.
It's more of a cacistocracy. That's a word we're going to have to dust off again. Cacistocracy. Cacistocracy. That's government by the worst or by thieves.
Copy.
The Chump Line is brought to you today, as always, by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer, reminding everyone who purchased any of our wicked awesome windows or doors in 2020 to make sure you take advantage of your tax credit when you file this year, proving once again that windows are a much better investment than toilet paper.
Howie, happy Inauguration Day. Joe Biden just issued an executive order hereby declaring that the favorite ice cream flavor of all Republicans shall heretofore be Rocky Road.
Oh, boy. Yeah, you see. Donald Trump, war criminal for getting two scoops when the quote-unquote reporters from Time magazine got one. Joe Biden,
How many times has he melted our hearts with his ice cream? That's from E! Online. It's not, but everything's on the level, and only fools suggest that there's any media bias. It's the same for any administration, because these are real professionals at their profession. It's not a trade or a racket. It's a profession. Fluffing Democrats.
Loving. So SAG-AFTRA is going to expel Donald Trump? That's hardly adequate. If they really want to end his career in showbiz, they'd cast him in something like The Gentleman from Boston.
You know, since they want to try Donald Trump, the Democrats want to try him even though he's not in office any longer. I think maybe in addition to AFTRA SAG throwing Donald Trump out of the union, maybe they should throw Ronald Reagan out of the union too. I know he's dead, but this is the new standard. You know, if someone offends political correctness, even if they're gone in one way or another, you still go after them, right? And Ronald Reagan was the president of the union. Donald Trump was just a card-carrying, dues-paying member.
When you look up in the dictionary the word rump swab, you see a picture of Chris Wallace with the quote, "Joe Biden just gave the best inaugural address I have ever heard."
Yeah, we have to play this again, and I'm sorry to be inflicting it upon you. And, you know, we're not going to be talking a lot about Joe Biden all that much, but we have to today, and his coat holders in the media. I mean, again, Fox got rid of Steyerwalt, and they got rid of his boss, I guess, in the office, kind of a behind the scenes guy. They fired them, but you know, they have to get rid of some other people. They have to get rid of some higher profile people like Chris Wallace. Listen to what he said today.
I thought it was a great speech. I've been listening to these inaugural addresses since 1961. John F. Kennedy, ask not. I thought this was the best inaugural address I ever heard.
There's no way any rational, sane person could say that. That was a terrible speech. It was just nothing but bromides and prevarications and evasions. And it wasn't even well delivered.
Does anybody have the Not My President flags that the Democrats used 4 years ago that I could borrow?
Yeah, if you find one, if you find two, send the second one to me if you can. 844-500-4242. 917 says, where was that Mencken quote? Can you post them perhaps on the website? Thanks, want to share them. That's a good point. I tweeted them out, Taylor. Maybe I should just type them up tonight and send them to you and we can post them on the website.
I'd imagine his quotes are already transcribed somewhere, no?
No, they are. I mean, I can, you could just pull it off of Twitter if you want. I tweeted it out. We could, let's put them up though, because I think these are all pretty, they're all pretty good. I got a lot more to read. These are 12 H.L. Mencken quotations on government, democracy, and politicians. H.L. Mencken was great on a number of different topics, but he was really at his best talking about politics.
So is the pandemic over now?
I'm glad you asked that question. I got a couple of headlines to read to you that I just saw during the break. This is from CNN. New COVID-19 cases declined 11% after hitting a peak last week. Go figure. Cases are in decline. How about this from a California TV station? California is, quote, starting to see decline, unquote, in COVID-19 cases, top health official says. Is it Joe Biden? Is there anything he can't do? He's ended the panic.
This day in our country's history, a day that will live in senility.
This is the greatest day of Joe Biden's life. If only he could remember what he was doing a couple hours ago.
Howie, now that Joe Biden's president, would today be considered the grimmest grim milestone in the history of grim milestones?
That's a word you're not going to hear any with words. You're not going to hear any more grim milestones. There are not going to be any more grim milestones. But the word you're going to hear is unexpectedly. The economy unexpectedly took a tumble last week. Gas prices unexpectedly rose as all fracking and coal mining was ended.
Hi, Howie. Governor Patrick calling. Wow, it's Wednesday afternoon and neither Howie Carr nor Coos ended up getting pardoned. Now, Merrick Garland's going to have a litany of crimes to bag you with, whether it be bootlegging cigarettes, rigging the license plate lottery, falsifying the Brown University postcard, spitting on toll takers, or stealing that table from Leechmere. Soon you'll be like Johnny Cash, broadcasting live from Folsom Prison. We're going to be fine.
If any of those charges were true and they are all just scurrilous allegations, the statute of limitations would have long since expired on each and every one of them. I lead a blameless life now, like the Catholic saint that Joe Biden cited today, Saint Augustine, author of
Hey,
A City of God, another book that Joe Biden has never dipped into, I dare say, much like Jane Joyce's Ulysses, as he calls James Joyce.
Hey, Howie, nice mention today by the big guy, huh? Oh, no, I don't mean Joe Biden. I mean Rush Limbaugh.
I knew what you meant, and I did appreciate him saying that those kind words about my column and reading so much of it on the air. We'll play a little bit more of it in a segment or two.
That was your last chump line message. Thank you for calling Howie Carr, you chump.
Officer Mark says, let me be the first to chant, impeach 46, impeach 46, impeach 46. Actually, Officer Mark, you were beaten to the punch by the new congresswoman from Georgia. She's already filed articles of impeachment against Joe Biden. So she was there first. You could just say, I second that motion. That's it for the Chump Line today. The Chump Line is the recorded voicemail message service of the Howie Carr Show. You can call and leave a message at any hour of the day or night, including weekends. The Chump Line number, if you'd like to leave such a message, 844-500-4242, 844-500-4242. Press 2 for the Chump Line. You can do it between 1 and 4 p.m. every day. 1 and 4 p.m., the Chump Line is open. Press 2 for the Chump Line. Leave your message. We may or may not play it at this time each weekday. The Chump Line is, if you didn't get enough of the Chump Line, I should say, you can always get chopped chumps. Those are the Chump Line messages that were left on the cutting room floor. We post our Chop Chumps as a podcast every night around 7 o'clock. And you can get Chop Chumps wherever you get your Howie Carr Show podcast. The Chump Line is brought to you by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer, reminding everyone who purchased any of our wicked awesome windows or doors in 2020 to make sure you take advantage of your tax credit when you file this year, proving once again that windows are a much better investment than toilet paper.
Howie, happy Inauguration Day. Joe Biden just issued an executive order, hereby declaring that the favorite ice cream flavor of all Republicans shall heretofore be Rocky Road.
The difference is it won't be favorite. That's the only change I made. It will be the only ice cream. That's Democrats. If it's not prohibited, it's mandatory. And if it's not mandatory, it's prohibited. That's the new world, and we're all living in it. I'm Howie Carr.
Keep it here, chumps. More Howie Carr after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Defensive Strategies in Manchester, New Hampshire. Defensive Strategies is the premier firearms training company in southern New Hampshire with more than 100 classes from beginner to instructor level. Come to where the trainers train. Visit defensivestrategies.org.
It's a new year and time for a new you. DiStefano Hair Restoration changed my life, and they can change yours too. My production director said when he saw a recent pic of me that you look great, like Benjamin Button. You're getting younger. That's quite the compliment, and I owe it to DiStefano Hair Restoration and Dr. Chris Hines. Many wait years before they get the hair restoration they deserve. Stop waiting and just get it done. You won't regret it, and you'll ask yourself, why did you wait so long? You can see my before and after photo shoot on their site at hairman.com. DeStefano Hair Restoration is taking all the necessary precautions to keep you safe during your visit. They also offer virtual consultations. Go to hairman.com today and schedule your free consultation and get the hair you deserve and have always wanted. Dr. Hines took care of me and he'll take care of you too. Visit them today at hairman.com.
Joe Biden doesn't have time for malarkey,
Taylor.
And he also doesn't have a lot of time for geography. Take a listen.
Can you find those Mencken quotes and just post them on the website, or do you want me to type them up tonight?
The quotes that you tweeted out, did you want more than that?
I was just saying that we'll just start those. If people like them, we can do more. There are a million Mencken quotes. Why don't you just take those?
Why don't we do this a little more thought out than just haphazard? Why don't you send me the quotes that you want and whatever captions you want with them, we can post them on the website.
Okay, I think we just, okay. Let's see here. Okay, I'll send them to you tonight. I'll send you the list of the 12, and I'm going to 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll send you like 6 of them, okay? And I'll just sure. I'll give you the numbers, and then you could just put them out, okay?
All right. Did you want anything to be said with the quotes?
No.
Okay.
No.
All right.
I'll just say H. I'll give you the line. Just say H. L. Mencken's quotes on the democracy in America. I'll read some of them right now, though. Fuller, thicker hair so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great. I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now, when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair. For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie. What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out? Get the hair you've always wanted. Hairman.com/Howie. And now, another minute of Madam Speaker, Nancy Pelosi.
But again, don't...
You have these wings, AOC and her group on one side.
That's like 5 people. They would say, play games, and then they'd say, open sesame, except we don't say sesame. We say, open Biden.
But no, I because we are not. We have no, the number is growing. We have 91 women. There are 115 women in Congress, 116. 15 are Republican. 91 are Democrats. I happen to be a manifestation of the women power that is coming forth now, but only one manifestation. It was like getting kicked in the back by a mule constantly. It was physical. It was so unbelievable. The Times found Lincoln. Not to be presumptuous to put ourselves in those categories, but the Times have found us.
Mother of mercy. Is this the end of Rico?
Howie Carr is back.
And the first order I'm going to be signing here is relates to COVID. And it's requiring, as I said all along, where I have authority, mandating masks be worn, social distancing be kept on federal property and interstate commerce, etc.
Actually, he's kind of backed away. I mean, if you're looking for a silver lining in a very dark cloud today, in a very dark winter, he initially said he was going to have a national mask mandate, right? So now he's just going to say it only applies on federal property and interstate transportation. I mean, he had no authority to issue a national mask mandate, but at least he's realized his handlers have realized the limitations on his powers. So there's not going to be a national mandate. This thing is coming to an end now, as you can see from these headlines. It's served its purpose. Now we'll have to have something else to keep the population in line. Here's another H.L. Mencken quote. Speaking of that, the whole aim of practical politics is to keep the populace alarmed and hence clamorous to be led to safety. by menacing it with an endless series of hobgoblins, all of them imaginary. We've been living it for the last 11 months with the hobgoblin. We'll get those quotes up tomorrow. I got some more that I'll read to you, but we'll post them on the website tomorrow. New year, new hobbies, and everything is better with Raycon wireless earbuds. With up to 6 hours of playtime, water and sweat resistant construction, and seamless Bluetooth pairing, you can take Raycon's premium audio anywhere you go. Right now, get 15% off at buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Will Joe Biden last his whole term?
I'm with the text there. The only way he makes it to 2025 is if that means 8:25 tonight.
And that might not even happen. 96% say no.
Oh, the economy is back on track. State Street Bank in Boston today unexpectedly announced layoffs. Unexpected layoffs. Unexpected increases in the price of gas, up 40%, up 40 cents since Election Day. 844-500-4242. Read you a couple more of these quotes, and we'll take some calls when we come back. 844-500-4242. Incidentally, if you want to get a copy of What Really Happened and check out some of our great deals on Cheap Bastard Deals, Valentine's Day is coming up. For today only, this is the last day. We did it yesterday as well. You can, if you go to HowieCarshow.com, click on store, HowieCarshow.com, click on store. We got a lot of great Cheap Bastard Deals, half-price deals for restaurants, IV clinics, cryo, body health and wellness clinics, all that stuff. Great Valentine's Day gifts, half price at HowieCarshow.com. Click on store. And if you order right now, today, you will get a free copy as well of What Really Happened, How Donald J. Trump Saved America from Hillary Clinton. 844-500-4242. And we'll be right back with your calls. Check out the website and the Cheap Bastard Deals. It's a great deal. Get the free book. I'm Howie Carr. You may have heard that many of the RV and camping shows have been canceled, but don't worry. Cold Springs RV is happy to announce the New England RV Show. This is Howie Carr, and if you're a camper, I've got two words of advice for you. Buy early. With the popularity of camping growing and manufacturers' constraints, the earlier you shop, the better. Visit Cold Springs RV in Ware, New Hampshire to make sure you get spring delivery. Go to NewEnglandRVShow.com to learn about this safe show.
Liberty Safe. If you're a gun owner, you know that name because they've worked so hard to earn the title of America's number one safe. And the area's best Liberty Safe dealer is Dependable Lock in Nashua. They have Liberty Safes in stock now. Keep your guns and other valuables locked up in a Liberty Safe. See the experts at Dependable Lock to learn more and see the full collection. LibertySafeNewHampshire.com. LibertySafeNewHampshire.com.
He's the gaffe that keeps on giving. Here's 1 minute of former Vice President Joe Biden.
You teachers who touched him, figuratively speaking.
Can you give me some coffee?
Well, I hope you touch him and tell him how much you love him too. But my point is, thanks. My point is, when you touch their hearts.
I get in trouble some things I say, but I want to tell you, just be straight up. I'm your president. With me, it starts here in my gut, goes to my heart, and then I articulate it.
And by the way, you know, I sit on the stand and it get hot. I got hairy legs that turn that turn blonde in the sun. And the kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down so it was straight and then watch the hair come back up again.
$1.2 billion. So you go ahead and you stack spaghetti sauce at a store in a supermarket. You control the guy or the woman who runs the run brings out the carts on a forklift.
So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap, and I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
Brace yourself, guys. Here's 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
I myself have always been for lowering the voting age to 16. I think it's really important to capture kids when they're in high school, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable.
That they wanted their voices to be heard.
I don't think our colleague is anti-Semitic. I think she has a different experience in the use of words. That's not the total package, but there are some of the major points of discussion, I would hope, from sea to shining sea, because they are not getting paid Republicans voted no. Wisdom from the kitchen of the Willard Hotel, yes, ma'am.
The president either doesn't know what he's talking about or doesn't want to know what he's talking about.
I tested positive. Let's use this example of me having it as proof that you can get it too. God forbid, the rest of us should be staying at home for our mothers and the people that we love, and to keep us farther apart will ultimately bring us closer together in this cause. We have to do everything we can to avoid being sick. No matter where the virus goes, the way to stop it will always be the same. Our collective conscientious actions. Staying home.
Staying home saves lives.
I don't want some jack loser, fat tire biker get in my face and in my space and talk to me. I don't want to hear it. Right here is the official re-entry from the basement.
You're a phony. Hey, this guy's a great big phony.
Cleared by CDC. A little sweaty. Just worked out.
Oh, my. Yeah. Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Did you notice the difficulty that former President Bill Clinton was having with the mask today? Got a lot of comments on Twitter. You would think that he'd be more familiar with how to use a prophylactic, which is what a mask is. But no. Maybe he didn't believe in prophylactics in his younger days.
How dare you?
844. I'm sorry. I couldn't resist it. I just couldn't resist saying that. Here's another quote from H.L. Mencken. Democracy is the theory that the common people know what they want and deserve to get it good and hard. Another one. Every election is a sort of advance auction sale of stolen goods. And there's going to be stolen goods by all the illegal aliens coming into the country. 201 says the next lie will be the illegal aliens in the caravan carry COVID immunity. Yeah, so again, look at the pictures. The New York Post had them on the front page yesterday. The gravy train. That's what we're now calling the caravans because it's a gravy train. He's ringing the dinner bell for him to just come up and get everything free in America. And if you look at the picture, some of them have the mask around their necks, you know, just for cosmetic purposes. But very few of them are actually wearing a mask. And a lot of them, most of them don't even have a mask around their neck, just as as some kind of a bandana. They're not into it. But we're supposed to have mandatory masks. mandatory mask. And he's very concerned about unemployment. So today he ended the Keystone XL pipeline, throwing hundreds, if not thousands, of union, good paid union workers out of jobs if it goes through. And he's going to allow the southern border to be overrun with people who'll be competing with all of these millions of people who've lost their jobs. 2 million in the restaurant industry alone are unemployed since COVID. 2.5 million. And he's going to increase the number of unemployment by raising the tipped minimum wage from $2.13 an hour federally to $15. What could possibly go wrong when you increase a wage by 7 times? Do you think mom and pop's diner is going to be able to pay the tipped waitress $15 an hour as opposed to $2.13 an hour? 844-500-4242. Bruce from the Met says, why isn't firing the Surgeon General racism 101? Yeah, that was one of the first people he got rid of, the Surgeon General, who happens to be a black person. And he was railing against systemic racism. Why was Dr. Adams the first one fired? 844-500-4242-860. I didn't see Hunter's baby mama today. you got to go down to that strip joint on Capitol Hill if you want to see the baby. No, she's moved back to Arkansas, I think. Kevin, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Kevin.
Hi, Howie. Thanks for taking my call. I'll be brief. I just want people to be reminded. I got pictures on my cell phone where last year, about a year ago, I was buying a gallon of gas in Union, Maine, mm-hmm. for less than $1.37 a gallon.
Wow.
And when these people's gas prices double, and it costs double to heat their house and double to build a house and all the things that go in with the price of fuel, I'm going to say Howie's famous words, elections have consequences. And I'll tell you right now, it's going to hurt.
I know. Look at the gas prices are already up. I put in my column of thank yous. Thank you for the lowest gasoline prices in decades. It's great what he did. And he ended our dependence on unstable Middle East oil producers. We don't have to suck up to them anymore, like we did in the 70s and the 80s and the 90s, you know? And I think the fact that we don't have to suck up to them anymore helped immeasurably in getting all those peace deals with Israel, increasing peace. And now they want to repeat. Now they want to bring back the Iranian nuclear deal. Iran is the problem over there. Even more so, Saudi Arabia is nothing to write home about, but Iran is the biggest problem right now. And they want to suck up to them again. 781. If I say I'm an illegal alien, can I ditch my mask? See, yes, you can. Si se puede. You don't need to wear no mask if you're an illegal alien. Who do you think this country's for? Citizens who work for a living or illegal aliens who just arrived this afternoon? Peter, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Peter.
Yeah. Hi, Howie. Calling you from Montreal. We love you. You're just great. Thank God for American radio. Howie, you mentioned that Keystone XL pipeline and illegitimate Joes moving to shut it down.
Yes.
Just quick note here. Listen, Justin Trudeau's not unhappy with that. It's the Western Canadian premiers.
Right. No, I said that. I said it's Western, like Alberta. They have, what is it, yeah. sand oil. It's tough to refine.
And Western Canada didn't vote for Trudeau at all. Western Canada's all conservative, so Trudeau, you know, snubs them. And now Joe and Justin are in bed. North America's become one huge swamp now. And they'll call me a lion, dog-faced pony soldier if you want. But, you know, Howie, I think what we got to do is we've got to rejig the map. We've got to take, you know, get about 13, 14, however million Canadians who are conservatives who would, you know, vote for Donald Trump in a heartbeat. And you know, if we can just rejig, maybe divide North America left and right, north and instead of north south, will be east west. You know,
but you know what would happen though, Peter? It's the same thing that's happening in the U.S. All the Americans from the failed states, you know, in on the East Coast from New York, Massachusetts, New Jersey, they move to the red states and ruin them. And on the West Coast, everyone would be moving from California, Oregon, and Washington up to British Columbia and Alberta and ruining those places, right?
Well, British Columbia is pretty much a lost cause anyway, because that's all left. You know, that's like California.
Oh, America. Okay.
But Alberta, Saskatchewan, you know, these are sort of the core Canadians. These are the sort of the real Canadians. The rest of us forget about. We're lost.
How many people in Saskatchewan and Alberta, you figure?
I think it probably amounts to about maybe, I'm a little weak on numbers, probably about 8 million. Yeah.
That would offset about 6 months of the illegal aliens crossing the border on the southern front.
And we wear masks too, Howie, over our noses.
You got to teach Bill Clinton how to do it. Thanks for the call, Peter. Keep listening up in Montreal on WVMT, one of my great affiliates that gets into Quebec province and also upstate New York, Plattsburgh, across the lake. 844-500-4242. Steve, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Steve.
How you doing, Howie? Happy belated birthday.
Thank you.
Hey, I just wanted to, how about doing a pool, instead of a death pool, a pool when Biden gets tossed out? I'd like June 4th.
Is that any particular date? Is that your birthday or anything like that?
Move on.
I think what they're going to do is try to get him through, or try to get him through 2 years. Because that way, if he gets 2 years, I think it's in the Constitution, if the vice president takes over for less than half the term, then the vice president can theoretically run for two complete terms. So that way they could get 10 years of the glory of Kamala Harris and her cackle laugh. That's what I think, that's the end game, or one of the end games here. 844-500-4242. Oh, you like my little funny, Madam Vice President. 844-500-4242. Angelo, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Angelo.
Yeah, Howie, I'm an immigrant myself, and I had to put when I petitioned for a family member, it took 10 years to come. Does that mean they open the borders to everybody as well? And the other thing I want to mention is that the Democrats claim there's so much, they're for equality and social justice. Ask any business owner in Roxbury, Dorchester, Mattapan, who are closed, who follow the guidelines, and they can't make it because, you know, Charlie Parker's going back and closing everybody out. And they don't have any help from the government. So I don't know what they're talking about. Black business go away, they don't come back. Thank you very much.
I know, Angelo. I mean, everybody's hurting. It's really bad. We're going to talk to somebody at 6 o'clock. She's up in New Hampshire, and she's been put out of business because she temporarily, at least, a yoga shop or yoga
studios,
a yoga studio. My wife goes to one all the time. I should know what the word. And she went down to the rally on the 6th of January, 2 weeks ago today, and she came back and started teaching her classes, and the state of New Hampshire shut her down, and she's getting doxxed. You can imagine what's happening to her. We'll talk more about this. It's across the board. It's all colors, and this minimum wage thing is insanity. I mean, it's real insanity, and no, it's getting very little attention from anybody. 844-500-4242. My friends at Eden Pure are extending their New Year's sale, but you need to act while you can. You can get the Thunderstorm air purifier at the lowest price offered to my listeners with code word Howie. The Thunderstorm is available for under $90 if you use that code word Howie, and shipping is free. Supplies are limited, so this sale won't last much longer. The Thunderstorm is a small device you can hold in your hand and plug into the wall to purify the air from any odor. It could be pet odors, kitchen smells, tobacco, or that damp smell in your basement. No filters are needed. I've seen much more expensive expensive comparable units in doctor's offices and have asked myself, why didn't they order the Thunderstorm? The Thunderstorm doesn't take up floor space and is quiet. Take advantage of this extended sale and experience for yourself what all the listeners are raving about. Go to EdenPure.com and put in code word Howie. That's EdenPure.com, code word Howie. Shipping is free. I'm Howie Carr.
Born in Maine, made in Massachusetts, and now a resident of the Sunshine State, Howie Carr, the original carpetbagger.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you today in part by Nauset Beach Inn. Open this winter for the first time in 63 years. Take advantage of their ocean view room rate while rooms are still available. Low price available only at NausetBeachInn.com.
What deal can we have, Crazy Nancy?
The Constitution does not say that a person can shout wolf in a crowded theater.
But to be clear, you're not taking any arrows out of your quiver. You're not ruling anything out.
Good morning. Sunday morning.
Chocolate. Candy.
Chocolate, and then we have some other chocolate here.
Consistently practice social distancing.
Why does AOC complain that you have not been grooming younger people for leadership?
I don't know. You'll have to ask her.
That was kind of sharp.
I'm not a big needle taker. I mean, I had a hard time getting my ears pierced. I'm not a big needle taker.
Mother Earth is angry. She's telling us.
What do you think is causing this erratic behavior?
I think that the president has always had erratic behavior.
I have ice cream in my freezer. I guess that's better than having Lysol in somebody's lungs.
Civilization as we know it is at stake.
I don't drink, but I'm happy to have ice cream with anybody anytime.
You've been hearing me talk about Superbeats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Superbeats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Superbeats are incredible. I take them twice a day, once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Superbeats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. Go to superbeetsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeatsradio.com/Howie.
I tested positive. Let's use this example of me having it as proof that you can get it too. God forbid, the rest of us should be staying at home for our mothers and the people that we love. And to keep us farther apart will ultimately bring us closer together in this cause. We have to do everything we can to avoid being sick. No matter where the virus goes, the way to stop it will always be the same. Our collective conscientious actions. Staying home.
Staying home saves lives.
I don't want some jack loser, fat tire biker get in my face and in my space and talk to me. I don't want to hear it.
Right here is the official re-entry from the basement.
You're a phony. Hey, this guy's a great big phony.
Cleared by CDC. A little sweaty. Just worked out.
Oh, my.
Excitable? You bet I'm excitable. We're trying to put a guilty man in the chair where he belongs. Someone stops telling us fairy tales and we're listening.
Howie Carr is back.
Thank you for trying to defund sanctuary cities where illegals run amok. Look, the thank yous go on and on and on here in Howie Carr's column in the Boston Herald from yesterday. It is a list of Trumpian achievements unparalleled by any president in our lifetime. It's the kind of stuff that people are not going to forget. It's the kind of substantive stuff that it's going to enable people to remember and hold on to Trump, the person, the president, the administration.
You know, he's right. It's like that caller from Maine was just saying, I mean, he's going to remember $1.37 a gallon for a long time. When are you going to see that again? When are you going to see gas prices under $2 a gallon with these people in control? They're insane. They don't care. They all got government vehicles, or they got trust funds, or they got these sweet government deals where they're getting paid and they don't have to go to work for a year at a time because of the COVID panic. Incidentally, State Street Bank, you know why they laid off all the 1,200 people today unexpectedly? They said the pandemic's over. They had apparently made a pledge that they wouldn't lay anybody off until the pandemic was over. But now Joe Biden's president, so there can't be a pandemic. There's no need for a pandemic anymore. Orange Man Bad is gone. So ollie oxen free. You can come out and fire your employees now, and the pandemic's over. Going forward, says Farmer John, I'd like to be known as Farmer Juan. Another guy says, I'm a 40-year-old American citizen. Can I get free tuition, or do I have to join the caravan? 508, your line about them coming here for a permanent vacation, that's a great line. You need to get that out there to others. Look at the numbers for welfare for people from Central America. It's over 75% of them are on welfare, the illegal aliens, in one form or another. Same thing in the Mideast. And he opened up the travel ban is over. So over 70% of travelers from the Mideast who come over here get on welfare, like the Sarnievs. And, if you're looking for a job, where are they going to get the jobs with the unemployment rate the way it is after the get rid of Donald Trump pandemic? Lyndon, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Lyndon.
Hey, Howie. How are you tonight?
Good.
I want to talk a little bit about the whole effect of the minimum wage in the restaurant industry. I've worked in the restaurant industry for about 10 years myself, and I can tell you firsthand, I've never worked in a kitchen where there's not an employee who's not a documented immigrant. It's an industry standard, and I really think that this $15 minimum wage is going to adversely affect the labor pool that comes to the country for these jobs. And it will not only cause a stall for them where they're unable to get employment because of these numbers, but it will also just cause detrimental effects for the restaurant owners.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, it'll be the end of a lot of restaurant owners that have even been able to survive this last year, Lyndon. I mean, this last year was a nightmare no one could have ever imagined. And now this on top of it, it's just ridiculous. And again, the quote from Biden in the second debate, there's no evidence when you raise the minimum wage, businesses go out of business. I mean, with Biden, you don't know, is he that stupid or is he lying? Does he never study or understand the the correlation between the cost of labor and the amount of labor that any business hires? Oh, he's never had a business. I forgot. Unless you want to include the Biden crime family as a business, but they don't have to worry about minimum wages. Dave, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Dave.
Yes, Howie. I just wanted to say, you know, the reason the SAG-AFTRA people probably threw Trump off the rolls so he wouldn't be able to collect any health insurance. They've already done that to thousands of their seniors, the union people, because they didn't want to pay out extra money. But their virtue is signaling everything else. You know, Norman Lloyd, the guy that fell off the Statue of Liberty in that Hitchcock film,
yeah,
he's still alive, 106.
Yeah, no, he's in our death pool every time. Yeah, I know who he is.
Well, they threw him off out of the
Really?
Yeah. And thousands of others to try to, you know, save money. But they'll virtue signal. We love women, but if you're a widow on the pension benefits, get lost.
Wow. I didn't know that. I haven't. I'm a member of AFTRA-SAG, and I've been getting the pension for the number of years since we tossed them out at the radio station I used to work at. So I was able to go on the pension very early. Yeah, I took a... I was like on group 4 in the public sector. I went out at 55. And so I've been collecting for a long time. But this, I mean, this is ridiculous. I mean, to throw the president of the United States off of the pension, out of a union. Nancy, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Nancy.
Howie, I happen to work on a very affluent island in Florida.
Yes.
I won't name where it is.
Yes.
And our restaurant closed last year due to COVID. Trying to find employees has been a nightmare because nobody, why would you want to work for what the minimum wage was at that point? Now at $15 an hour, we can't afford to hire people.
So what do you think you're going to do long term, Nancy?
I don't manage the restaurant. I actually work in the hotel.
Yeah. Yeah. The big chains are all going to go to kiosks, like that you see some places already. I'm Howie Carr.
Like most companies, we here at Matthews Brothers are pretty proud of our website. Not so proud that we go around asking total strangers to visit it or anything like that, but proud enough to ask you to. Now, you might think that's the dumbest thing I've heard all day. Why the heck would I want to visit MatthewsBrothers.com? Where's the fun in that? And we'd be like, you don't have to make it personal, dude. There's lots of fun stuff to do there. And you'd be like what? And we'd be like the visualizer. And you'd be like, what the heck's a visualizer? And then we'd tell you. The visualizer is this nifty little application that allows you to completely remodel the exterior of your house. Play with different colors and styles to design the virtual home of your dreams. You'll have hours of fun this winter creating such visual masterpieces as a spruce green window with barn red sash and gray 4.5-inch banded casing and historic sill nosing. Then, once the thrill of that is worn off, you can play with the roofing and siding. You can learn more about our wicked awesome main-made windows and doors, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. Matthews Brothers with one T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
Are we starting to feel bad for Joe Biden? Sorta. Are we going to play his gaffes anyway? Of course.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate for the United States Senate.
Now we need to stand behind Jamie Harrison, the next president of the United States Senate.
I'm looking forward to appointing the first African-American woman to the United States Senate.
Just like here in California, I mean, here in Nevada.
Back in the spring, late fall, late winter, early fall, anyway, you know what I mean.
Look, tomorrow's Superstar Tuesday. I tell you what, I'm rushing ahead, aren't I?
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by the thing.
It says you cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
We'll see who's sleepy.
Mr. Vice President, thank you.
All right, Chuck, thank you very much.
All right, it's Christmas.
Sometimes I wake up and I think it's 1920, not 2020.
Here's 1 minute of Congresswoman Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez.
There's a lot of restaurants that are feeling the pain of racism, where people are literally not patroning Chinese restaurants. They're not patroning Asian restaurants because of just straight up racism around the coronavirus. So,
you know, only in America does the president, when the president tweets about liberation, does he mean go back to work? When we, you know, have this discussion about going back or reopening, I think a lot of people should just say no. We're not going back to that.
One of the, I know it sounds banal. Do we know how long puppies are allowed to stay with their mothers after a dog has given birth?
I don't.
8 weeks. Wow. So the market has decided that women and people who give birth deserve less time with their children than a dog.
So the whole premise of the Green New Deal is that we're screwed.
Listening to the Howie Carr Show.
Now's the perfect time to get a pair of premium wireless earbuds, and Raycon is the way to go. Raycon started about half the price of other premium brands on the market, and they sound just as amazing. And Raycon's everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet. You get 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a comfortable, noise-isolating fit. perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcasts. Raycon was founded by Ray J, and celebrities like Cardi B and J.R. Smith have already given Raycons their seal of approval. I love my Raycons, and Grace loves hers, too.
Howie, I love my Raycons. Best birthday gift ever.
I listen to much better music than she does, though.
Hey, that's not true.
Now it's your turn to see what the hype is all about. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie.
And now, 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
It is a bill that is much needed for our farmers and ranchers. I think there are only 47 votes against it in the House of Representatives. The American people should know the source of it. Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure.
No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable. And I talked to Chuck last night to say, you know, we haven't had an answer. There are other things that are going on that are newsworthy. And I think I think you'd have more viewers or readers if people addressed concerns that people have. The list goes on about the jurisdiction.
We are now effective today requiring all counties to close their indoor activities, their indoor operations in the following sectors: restaurants, wineries, tasting rooms. A few weeks ago, I was asked to go to a friend's 50th birthday. I made a bad mistake. Instead of sitting down, I should have stood up.
Stay at home as much as possible. Put those social gatherings on hold, including extra care for Thanksgiving.
Denver's mayor told you to stay home for Thanksgiving, then he got on a flight to go see family out of state.
Some people calling Supervisor Kuehl a hypocrite. Now, on November 24, she voted to ban outdoor dining, and on the very same day, she was spotted eating out.
I take responsibility for trusting the word of the neighborhood salon that I've been to over the years. As it turns out, it was a setup. So I take responsibility for falling for a setup. This salon owes me an apology.
What they do.
You're listening to The Howie Carr Show.
This is Charlie Baker.
Hey, everybody. Massachusetts Governor Charlie Baker here.
And these are his friends.
There's a group of about 10 people outside of work that represent the entire universe of the community that I've spent time with and my wife has spent time with since March.
In the world of Charlie Baker and his friends, the real world of panic porn, political leaders cannot survive without absolute power, and the public can't be expected to blindly follow orders without first hearing a made-up story.
We spent time with about 10 people, period.
We have a lot of friends we have not seen for months, and we don't know when we will see them.
There are lots of people we haven't seen in, like, forever.
It's a confusing, nonsensical, follow-the-science world, but it's the only world they know.
Those are the rules in this game that we all need to play by.
And they're the only friends Charlie Baker has.
My wife and my circle of friends has gotten very small.
Here at the Howie Carr Radio Network, we're all about saving you money. We want you to cut out the middleman and buy direct from our great sponsors. And to help you save, I've put together a cheat sheet. For instance, if you go to EdenPure.com, you'll find the Thunderstorm Air Purifier, and you can save $10 using code Howie. You can also get Eden Pure's Gen 30 heater and save even more money with code Howie Deal. Do you have a dirty, dingy carpet that could use some freshening up? Head over to Genesis950.com, use code Howie, and get a gallon of their cleaner, free shipping, and other goodies with code Howie. Put a little pep in your step with Super Beats. Get more bang for your buck and do some good for your heart by going to superbeatsradio.com/Howie. While you're at it, give your ears a treat too, and listen to your favorite music and podcasts with premium earbuds from Raycon. Get them at buyraycon.com/Howie. And finally, make cooking easier with HelloFresh. They'll send you easy-to-follow recipes and all the ingredients you need, but only if you visit HelloFresh.com/Howie. Cut out the middleman, save money, and take advantage of these deals now.
The Moonbats always say Donald Trump isn't very bright. But what about Barack Hussein Obama? Let's listen to some of his greatest hits.
I've now been in 57 states. I think one left to go. I don't know what the term is in Austrian.
The Cambridge police acted
stupidly. And there has never been any man or woman more qualified for this office than Hillary Clinton.
There are neighborhoods around the country where it is easier for a 12 or 13 year old to purchase a gun and cheaper than it is for them to get a book.
I believe in the Second Amendment. It's there written on.
Better strap yourself.
Give me the name of her spa,
the
too.
Howie Carr Show.
We'll write the
Zenden Spa,
chapter,
right? Zenden Spa.
The United States of America, the American story.
Zen Den. Those are English words.
I know. Zen Den Spa. Zen. I know. Den. I said it. Okay. Just give me your name then.
Joanna Chippy.
Joanna Chippy. Okay.
Like this.
Oh, Christ.
Muskrat Susie. Muskrat Sam. Do the jitterbug out of Muskrat Land.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Just wanted to comment. I don't know if anyone else is struck by just seeing everyone masked. Even the Republicans are in masks. There's no longer that social pressure from Donald Trump.
There's no pressure. I am not myself. I feel weak and ineffectual. I'm not Kramer.
Goodbye. We love you. Have a good life. We will see you soon.
I did it my way.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
And so it begins. The White House website contact form, as of this afternoon, now asks you what your pronouns are. Thank God Orange Man Bad is gone. Okay. Joanna Chippy is a woman from southern Maine, and she has a yoga studio in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. It's called the Zen Den Spa. And 2 weeks ago, Joanna decided to go down to Washington to attend the rally to protest the election returns. And when she got back, everything caved in around her. And she's joining us tonight to tell us what happened to her and her business when she got back from the rally. Joanna Chippy, thanks for being with us here on the Howie Carr Show.
Howie Carr, I'm honored to be here tonight. Thank you.
Thanks for coming on. So you went to the rally and you came back. You weren't arrested. You didn't break in. You didn't get tear gassed. You were like 99.9% of the people who were there. You know, it was just a peaceful conservative Woodstock type event for you. So you come back to
Absolutely.
New England, and what happens?
All right. So I get back to New England. You know, I came back so exhausted, as equally as high, if you will, off just the abundant American spirit, right?
Yeah.
So I get home and on Zen Den Yoga on my business, I post an Insta story, which lasts for 24 hours, of a picture of me doing a handstand with the Washington Monument in the back. And I'm thinking, this is a cool picture. You know, my handstand, the
right.
straight line of the monument. It's a really cool picture. And then on my personal page, I posted me on the Capitol lawn, just giving a peace sign. No words, no nothing. I wake up Friday morning, January 8th, and I am floored. There is those pictures with a red arrow to my face saying, Portsmouth, beware. This is your Nazi terrorist, insurrectionist, white supremacist. Boycott her business now. We need to put her to bed. She has no place in our community or any community. They go on to say, here's the number in the email to the DOJ, and here's the number in the email to the FBI. Let's report her. Unbelievable.
Report her for what?
Exactly. Everybody's claiming that I was an insurrectionist because that's what the MSM was claiming. But I got to tell you, Howie, never was a part, nor did I witness any violence. It was, like you said, a love fest, a red, white, and blue America fest. And part of the reason why people were chiming in about the DOJ is because, you know, God forbid I go back to work the next day. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, because they in New Hampshire, they have a quarantine, correct?
Yes, they have a draconian executive order.
Chris Sununu is not as crazy as the neighboring governors, but that's pretty crazy what he did with that that order. And of course, I've been mentioning this all day. Now that it's over, and they've proved their point of trying to shut down free speech, the Washington Post reports today: self-styled militia members plan to storm Capitol days before attack, court documents say. The president didn't incite an insurrection. First of all, there was no insurrection. There was just a handful of people that got through. But, you know, 99.9% were just exercising their freedom of speech. Yet they call the riots in all these cities, including Boston, where there was looting and arson and police officers were shot at, if not killed. They call those peaceful protests, but they want to put you out of business. So what did the state do? What did the state do to you, Joanna? I mean,
the hypocrisy is insane. So on Monday, the 11th, that is when I get the email from the DOJ saying, hey, give us a call. We've gotten some complaints. Now, seeing and judging due to the severity of the doxing and defamation, I really wasn't surprised in a sense. And I just have to say, although there is a mandate, you know, around this whole country, especially in New Hampshire here, just because I choose not to wear a mask due to medical exemptions does not mean I don't think COVID is real. I have empathy and compassion for the lives that have been lost, of course, but just because I choose not to wear a mask does not mean, again, I don't think it's real, but I just choose to prioritize my life, my liberty, and my freedom over fear. That's it. So Monday, I get that email. I get a cop, comes right into Zenden. Tuesday, I get a cop, comes right into Zenden. Now they're doing compliance checks. Wednesday morning, I get a cop. This time he has a 7-page printout of the executive order. Wednesday night, I get another cop. This time with a 3-page printout of a warning claiming that I will be arrested due to misdemeanor criminal charges and further charge $2,000 a day if I continue because I went against the executive order of not quarantining for 2 weeks. Why should I have to sacrifice 2 weeks of my business just to go to peacefully protest?
Well, you wouldn't have if you'd gone to a BLM or Antifa riot.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Again, the hypocrisy is ridiculous. You know, there was a great article in the Portsmouth Herald here on the Seacoast. It wasn't an article, but somebody had written a letter in to the editor, and I'd like to read it real quick. It's like 2 paragraphs.
Sure.
So it's in, okay, so that's the thing. So the Portsmouth Herald, the local Herald, I was front page this past Saturday morning.
What was the headline?
Front page.
What was the headline? Nazi insurrectionist, white supremacist, something like that?
The headline was something along the lines of Zenden owner issued warning after going to Trump rally. And again, I wasn't required to shut down. I didn't get a fine. How many businesses, Howie, in just New Hampshire alone get warnings? I can't be the only one. And is this front page? You've got to be kidding me. All right. So today there is an open letter. It says Zenden yoga owner harassed for supporting President Trump. And this is a letter to the editor. It says, as I read about the New Hampshire Attorney General receiving 13 complaints about Zenden yoga, I was astonished. The complaints are clearly intended to punish a person who may support President Trump. Implying it is about public safety does not pass the straight-faced test, not even close. Those of you who complained, look at yourselves in the mirror, be honest, and ask if you are really concerned about safety or just angry that someone may support Donald Trump. I'm asking, will the New Hampshire Attorney General's office track and serve all persons who travel to Washington for President-elect Biden's inauguration with quarantine notices? Will the Portsmouth Police Department enforce the quarantine of Biden supporters with the same deal and vigor they did to me? None of this has anything to do with public safety. It's just simple hate-filled political retribution.
Do you know any of the 13 people? Did they identify them to you, or did they identify themselves?
They did not identify them to me. And, you know, what I find very fascinating is a lot of the people who are very opinionated behind their screens, I've never met in my life before, but they seem to know a lot about me.
From social media. This is the same thing. This is the same thing that happened to Nate Nickerson down on the Cape. This is happening to people all over. People who went down to the rally, behaved themselves, did nothing wrong, took a day off from work, small business owners or, you know, skilled workers. And they're being doxed and destroyed. This is ridiculous. Do you think any of the 13 people could have done what you did in front of the Washington Monument, Joanna Chippy?
Probably not. I mean, I got to tell you, I've met people from, you know, San Diego who are going through the same thing. I've met somebody in Orlando, Florida, who's going through the same thing. And it's like, all right, I got to tell you, because Jude, who put me kind of in touch with you, Jude wants me to tell you, I'm not guilty. All right.
I saw your picture, Joanna. I know you're not guilty. I would suggest anyone who wants to just Google Joanna Chippy, C-H-I-P-I, and you can see how not guilty she is at the Zen Den Spa. How can people support you, Joanna? What could they do?
So I've met a group of really amazing people this past week who, again, are just seeing that this is frankly unacceptable and disgusting that this is happening in the United States. So there is a website, chipinforfreedom.org. And you can read about my story there. You can even see the two famous pictures of me. You know, Howie, as I look at these pictures, and I know I sent them to you, I'm looking at them and I'm saying, you know what? If this is what violence looks like, I must be in a different dimension. I mean, that mainstream media has got people thinking 2 + 2 = 5. You know what I'm saying? It's ridiculous, the manipulation and the corruption that's going on.
Do you think there's some jealousy here, too, on top of political dementia that's going on with the hatred of Donald Trump, that there's some jealousy of you? I mean, being a young, good-looking woman who's athletic, and the people, I'm guessing the people who ratted you out are not any of what I just listed off as characteristics.
I mean, maybe, and that's what a lot of people keep telling me. I mean, I got to tell you, the Seacoast community, there are yoga studios publicly just posting my face. Stay away from this woman and her studio. She's an insurrectionist. How can these people make such federal false claims and get away with it? Where is the line between free speech and defamation? And that is why I need legal help. So anybody out there, please reach out. You know, I've talked to 3 lawyers that basically say this is a very steep, long road. You know, I'm 31 years old. I expanded to my second location 7 months before COVID hit, and I was forced to shut down for 3 months. Like, come on, you know what I'm saying?
So what's
still paying rent for those 3 months?
What's your web address again, Joanna? So we'll tweet it out too, actually. But give us your web address one more time so people can get in touch with you.
Thank you. It's Chip, C-H-I-P-N, for freedom, and it's F-O-R, and that's .org.
Chipinforfreedom.org. Joanna, are you open again?
I am open, yes.
But not you. You've completed your fortnight in the gulag.
Exactly. So yesterday was my first day back to the studio. You know, I needed last weekend, you know, with people saying put her to bed, what does that mean? Is that a threat? I mean, for God's sake, my boyfriend's CEO reached out to him. They've gone after his businesses. They've attacked my grandmother's business in York Beach, Maine. I mean, just taking over her Google reviews. These people will do anything and everything to straight up cancel me. And cancel culture is killing forgiveness and redemption. And isn't this America? It's ridiculous.
Let us know. We'll talk to you again, Joanna. And good luck. Thanks for standing up to try to preserve your freedoms and all of our freedoms. And we have it's 207 says definitely not guilty there. All right. Check her out online. Thank you, Joanna Chippy at Zen Den Spa in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, and her website, chipinforfreedom.org. Every year, all you hear is new year, new me. That usually means you'll be picking up better habits or trying to new things. The new habit I'm trying to pick up is exercising every day. I go out on the bike every morning, do about 4 or 5 miles right at dawn. And it's great. I like doing it. It's flat down here. But, you know, sometimes it gets a little boring. And it's great to have those Raycon earbuds in my ear so I can listen to my music. I'm not bothering anybody else. And they're great. No matter what kind of close quarters you're in, you can do whatever you want, listen to whatever you want, podcast, whether it's following along to directions in the kitchen, binging an audiobook while learning to knit, or powering through a new workout with a pumped up playlist in your ear. A pair of Raycon wireless earbuds can make any activity easier and a better time. I recommend them wholeheartedly. Raycon makes great sound accessible to everyone. Their wireless earbuds start at half the price of other premium audio brands. And guess what? If you think having white stems dangling out of your ears looks ridiculous, that's something you don't have to worry about with Raycons. They come in a range of stylish colorways, but always with a comfortable in-ear fit for a more discreet look. And they don't just look great. Raycons perform wherever you take them with up to 6 hours of playtime, water and sweat resistant construction, and Bluetooth that pairs quickly and seamlessly. The Raycons make any activity more pleasurable. And if you've heard me say all this before, and if you still don't have a pair, I've really got to wonder why. Right, Taylor?
You know, incidentally, my birthday came and went, Howie. I don't have any Raycon earbuds yet.
You don't?
I've never even.
Grace tried. And I have them.
They look great.
The mailroom manager has them.
Say about them, but I've never so much as even tried them.
Oh, well, I think we can arrange that.
Oh, great!
And you can listen to Frank Sinatra 24/7 on your Raycon wireless
earbuds.
We'll
have the Cycles album going on for a little while.
So I'm down, and so I'm out. I think I'll listen to that tomorrow on my ride. Raycon's offering 15% off all their products for my listeners, and here's what you've got to do to get it. Go to buyraycon.com/Howie. That's it. You'll get 15% off your entire Raycon order. So feel free to grab a pair and a spare. That's 15% off at buyraycon.com/Howie. Buyraycon.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
He's the guru of craft.
Sorry, I didn't mean to put you under the bus there.
No, that's okay.
Guard.
We'll get you some.
Thanks. Biden, sorta. Are we going to play his gaps anyway? Of course.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate for the United States Senate.
Now we need to stand behind Jamie Harrison, the next president of the United States Senate.
I'm looking forward to appointing the first African-American woman to the United States Senate.
Just like here in California, I mean, here in Nevada.
Back in the spring, late fall, late spring, late winter, early fall, anyway, you know what I mean.
Look, tomorrow's Superstar Tuesday. I tell you what, I'm rushing ahead, aren't I? We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by the thing.
We can open it up.
You cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
We'll see who's sleepy.
Mr. Vice President, thank you.
All right, Chuck, thank you very much.
All right, it's Christmas.
Sometimes I wake up and I think it's 1920, not 2020.
Hair loss is not one of life's more enjoyable experiences. If you're looking to fill in your hairline or reverse years of hair loss, DiStefano Hair Restoration will create a result that will be a transformative experience. The result of my IGT procedure was quite remarkable. I now have fuller, thicker hair, so I can even wear it a bit longer. There are a few major decisions I've made in my life that I wish I did sooner. My hair restoration is number one. It was by far one of the best moves I've ever made. My hair looks awesome, and the confidence from having a full head of hair again has left me feeling great. I used to look in the mirror and dreaded seeing my ever-increasing bald spot. Now, when I look in the mirror, I see the new me with a full head of thick hair. For information on how to make the same choice I did, go to hairman.com/Howie. What are you waiting for? More hair to fall out? Get the hair you've always wanted. Hairman.com/Howie.
They're outlandish, they're outrageous, and they're hypocrites. They're the women of The View.
Bernie was so menschy in that moment, like a real guy. I actually am aroused by him.
Timothy McVeigh was a Christian. Just saying.
Hitler was a Christian.
Well, he didn't like the Catholics.
Trump needs to be medicated and hospitalized at this point, or he is going to just...
kill all of us. I mean, do we have to wait till the hammer and sickle is on the American flag before we stand up to this guy?
Joy, you've worn blackface.
I did not go in blackface, please.
No, she was not in blackface.
Thank you. It was a Halloween party. I went as a beautiful African woman.
Did you have tanning lotion on, Joy?
A little. I had makeup that was a little bit darker than my skin.
I'm hoping Dr. Jill becomes a surgeon general. She's a hell of a doctor.
Whoopi, you said that Roman Polanski, it wasn't rape.
I know it wasn't rape.
Child molest, maybe? I'm not sure.
It was something else, but I don't believe it was rape.
Hold up!
Just when I thought I was out, they pulled me back in.
Howie Carr is back.
And I can only say this, we have worked hard. We've left it all, as the athletes would say, we've left it all in the field. We don't have to come and say, we'll never say in a month when we're sitting in Florida, we're not going to be looking at each other and saying, you know, if we only worked a little bit harder, you can't work harder.
It's so true. I mean, that's all you could say when it's over, you know, win or lose. You just have to think to yourself that you gave it 110%, as they say. And certainly Donald Trump did that. New year, new hobbies, and everything is better with Raycon wireless earbuds. With up to 6 hours of playtime, water and sweat resistant construction, and seamless Bluetooth pairing, you can take Raycon's premium audio anywhere you go, unless, like Taylor, you don't have a pair yet, but we'll get him one. We'll get him a pair. Right now, get 15% off at buyraycon.com/Howie. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Will Joe Biden last his whole term?
No, of course not.
96% say no.
All right. We just spoke to Joanna Chippy from the Zen Den Spa in Portsmouth, New Hampshire. And she's been, they're trying to cancel her for going down to the rally. And 603 says, same thing happened to the Troy, New Hampshire police chief. There have been death threats against him and town officials. Look it up. We did. We tried to get him on. No one from the town of Troy wants to come on. I mean, they're taking it very seriously. They got emails or texts or whatever saying they were going to execute the chief of police, execute him for going down to the rally. I mean, this is how unhinged they are. It's ridiculous. And, you know, I hope she can get a lawyer. I hope all these people can get lawyers. Nate Nickerson, and she's right. It's going on all over the country. Limerick guy says the people that went down to Plug's inauguration today from New Hampshire aren't going to face any of this BS that Joanna has had to put up with. This is absurd. 844-500. We're going to take a lot of calls when we come back, and we got some more cuts to play, everybody. And if you want to get a copy of What Really Happened for free, go to our website, HowieCarrShow.com. Click on store. Any cheap bastard deal you buy today, every cheap bastard deal, you get a free copy of What Really Happened, my book about the 2016 campaign. Good deal. I'm Howie Carr. You may have heard that many of the RV and camping shows have been canceled, but don't worry. Cold Springs RV is happy to announce the New England RV Show. This is Howie Carr, and if you're a camper, I've got two words of advice for you. Buy early. With the popularity of camping growing and manufacturers' constraints, the earlier you shop, the better. Visit Cold Springs RV in Ware, New Hampshire to make sure you get spring delivery. Go to NewEnglandRVShow.com to learn about this safe show.
Alexander Hamilton said, "Those who stand for nothing will fall for anything." This is Toby from Cape Gunworks. When our founding fathers drafted the Second Amendment, there was no question of its meaning. Today, if you have questions, come to Cape Gunworks for some advice, training, or to send a few rounds downrange. We have a fully stocked pro shop with a huge selection of guns, crossbows, archery, classes, rentals, 15-lane range, and a friendly staff. Come on down to Cape Gunworks, Airport Road, Hyannis, or CapeGunworks.com.
President Trump is clearly ethically unfit and intellectually unprepared to be the president of the United States.
And I support Chairman in the coming weeks. The House will hold hearings. Congresswoman Harris, Congressman
Senator, did I say Senator? Senator Harris. He's our president, and I would rather he not be taking something that has not been approved, especially in his age group and in his, shall we say, weight group, what is morbidly obese, they say. So completely inappropriate in so many ways that it's almost a given. It's like a child who comes in with mud on their pants or something. That's the way it is. They're outside playing. That's what it is. He comes in with doggy do on his shoes, and everybody who works with him has that on their shoes too. But I only will do that if you tell me that this legislation is worthy of George Kirby's name. This movement of moment of national anguish.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
200 moms, dads, sons, daughters, and grandparents who are no longer with us.
I think it's up to 30,000 people have died.
Over 600,000 dead, 600 plus thousand people.
60,000.
60.
We're in the middle of a pandemic that had cost us more than 85,000 jobs, lives of millions of people.
Now we have over 120 million dead from COVID.
200 million people have died.
205 million people.
210,000 people have died.
4 million existing billion, 500,000. 50,000.
A class of 25, you end up having two classes of 12, for example.
But you know, in the 2020 census, which is now two censuses ago.
The Oval, back in May 9, 2019, a $15 million, or $15,000, $15 minimum wage.
I got to the Senate 180 years ago.
Joe Biden accuses Trump of being a racist, but if you listen to Biden's comments, you would agree that he doth protest too much.
If you take a test where you're taking cocaine or not, what do you think, huh? Are you a junkie?
He's the first mainstream African-American who is articulate and bright and clean. And
Madam President, we have predators on our streets.
That kid wearing a hoodie may very well be the next poet laureate and not a gangbanger.
They are beyond the pale, many of those people.
God love you, you've been here all day. My Lord, you may feel like you're being incarcerated.
We have no choice but to take them out of society.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
I think the two-party system is good for the South and good for the Negro.
They're going to put you all back in chains.
Unlike the African-American community, with notable exceptions, the Latino community is an incredibly diverse community with incredibly different attitudes about different things.
If you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, then you ain't black.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show. Newsbusters just did some quotes from MSNBC today. These aren't audio quotes. They just transcribed them. Let me read you some of this stuff. And then I'll read you who said it. Biden is like Lincoln, who will rise up, punish the, quote, old America, unquote, to end this civil war. That's Joy Reid. I don't believe Abraham Lincoln said he was punishing the old America. Lawrence O'Donnell, stop the hammering. Biden gave the speech of his life. It was astonishing, poetic, and realistic. Really? Michael Beschloss, he's a presidential historian. We're going to hear a lot from presidential historians from now on. Isn't it great America got its happy ending with Democrats in power? A happy ending in the Oval Office? Okay.
make your own Bill Clinton joke there. Casey Hunt, NBC Capitol Hill correspondent. Joe Biden gave an American and patriotic speech, not a politics first speech. No, when he talked about racists and white supremacists and they have to stop the lying. Brian Williams, the you know, the liar, the who makes stuff up. America is back and under new management. Meet the new boss, same as the old boss. How about this one? This talk about irony alert. Al Sharpton. This is the guy who said that they had to drive the white interlopers out of Harlem, 125th Street. And one of his radio listeners took him at his word and torched Freddie's Fashion Mart and killed 7 people. But now Sharpton today demanded accountability for those who incite violence. Between Nicole Wallace and Joy Reid, they said that the GOP should be blessed by Joe Biden's grace, unquote, that he didn't ban them from attending. Here's Nicole Wallace. Having crushed Republicans, thank goodness Biden has restated American values. Brian Williams, again, he lied. He says that Republicans have a whole lot of explaining to do for their lies. Rachel Maddow, Harris being sworn in sent this surge of energy through those assembled. That's after the New York Times editor got a chills down her whatever from when the plane landed at Joint Base Andrews. I just can't take any more. Trucker Jason, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead.
Hey, Howie. I'm coming to you live from Truck Stop in Connecticut, and I had a local media on, and I couldn't believe what they were saying about how finally they have a president now that's taking the coronavirus seriously and going to listen to the doctors and scientists. And I'm thinking to myself, no wonder we're so divided as a country. But the real point that I'm making is Biden did sign an executive order today, right, for stop building the wall.
Yes,
so
he did.
On his first day, he's unemployed, probably what, over 450 people maybe?
Yeah, and how about the Keystone XL pipeline? There's a lot more than 450 people working on that. And then they're the people that are at the oil refineries in the Gulf that aren't going to be able to process the sand tar oil that's coming in from Alberta and Saskatchewan. And how about the fact that all these Americans are unemployed, and he says he wants to do something about it, but he's letting in hordes of illegal aliens from south of the border, and he's concerned about COVID. If he's concerned about COVID, why is he letting all these people that don't wear masks and are more likely to be testing positive, according to all the stories I've seen from Central America, and who aren't going to be working for a living? They're going to get free health care when they get sick.
Exactly. Did you see the inauguration? They were supposedly shaking hands and stuff, even though they were wearing a mask.
Right. Garth Brooks. He was shaking hands with everybody after he sang. Yeah. Where was the social distancing?
As I say, not as I do.
Yeah. There'll be a lot of that. Thanks for the call, Trucker Jason. Officer Mark says 2 words that are about to disappear. Fact check. Not just grim milestone. We're going to have this fact check is going to, there aren't going to be any more fact checks. That what I just read to you from MSNBC, that's what's going to pass for a fact check now. Rich, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Rich.
Hi, Howie. I'm politically neutral, but this is kind of, to put it in a sick way, entertainment for me. President Biden said today in his speech, if you didn't vote for me, just give me a chance. And if you don't like what I do, so be it. Exercise your right to dissent and protest peacefully. So the president wants a chance to give people a reason to dissent. So before attending a protest, those people need to give him enough rope before attending a protest.
And I know. I got it, Rich. 844-500-4242. He reached out for unity, but he came out against domestic terrorism. And the new definition of domestic terrorism is anyone who deviates from Democrat orthodoxy and hegemony. If you, you're a racist, white supremacist, terrorist, insurrectionist like Joanna Chippy, if you have any kind of independent thought, you will be silenced. And you will have to produce your papers, unless you're an illegal alien, of course, in which case you'll be provided everything free in America. Session, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Session.
Your papers, please.
Yavol.
Howie, your show. Howie, I have two questions. Number one, Washington Post said, remember, democracy dies in darkness on the day Trump was inaugurated.
Yes.
Now, according to me, democracy died today again. And the second thing is, Trump declassified so many, all the documents, right?
Yes.
Question is, John Brennan, James Clapper, Susan Rice, Samantha Parr, will they face any justice at all?
You know the answer to that, Session. They're gonna broom the charges against this guy, Kevin Kleinsmith, who's the lawyer who falsified the documents that they presented to the FISA courts. What are the odds that he's going to do time when he's sentenced on January 29th, Session? I think the odds are infinitesimal. There's no way he's going to be hailed. I'll bet he's not disbarred either. He may be suspended for, he's a lawyer. I'll bet he might be suspended for 6 months, but there's no way they're going to disbar him. I mean, think about that. The CIA sends the FBI a document. They ask, what's Carter Page's status? They say, he was an asset for us in an investigation of Russian spies, an asset. And this crooked Democrat, Kevin Kleinsmith, changes the memo to he's not an asset for us, because if he prints the truth, they're not going to get the warrant to spy on Carter Page, which is just a way to spy on Donald Trump. And he's the one guy who's been prosecuted, the one guy. That guy, Wolf, who worked for the Senate Intelligence Committee, for Burr, in other words, the guy whose case against him, the senator, his case for insider trading was dropped today by the Justice Department because he's part of the swamp. So this guy, Wolf, he was sleeping with the New York Times reporter. He's like 60 years old and she's 23. And he's giving her all the FISA warrants. And that's a total violation, total felonies. They dropped the charges. He gets to plead guilty to a misdemeanor. And she's moved up to the Albany Bureau in New York, the slut that he's trading sexual favors for classified information. I mean, it's just outrageous. Nobody has been punished for any of this crap that happened. And they're trying to kill people like Joanna Chippy at the Zen Den Spa, or Nate Nickerson at Arnold's in East Ham. And there's hundreds, if not thousands, of people like that. They're being punished for their exercising their First Amendment rights, and these deep state swamp creatures are committing felonies and laughing all the way to the bank. They dropped the investigation of the felonious leaks of the conversations, the taped conversations, wiretapped conversations between General Flynn and the Russian ambassador, which weren't illegal, but leaking them to the Washington Post was illegal. All investigations ended today. Rocky, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Rocky.
Hey, Howie. I didn't watch any of that dementia fool. But anyway, this idiot talking about we'll grow back America better and everything. America was great. It was better. This idiot, he wants to shut down fracking and put all these people and have mortgages and kids in school and gas payments, car payments. This loser's going to put 30 million people out of work, and he's trying to unify the country.
How about that? You know, I appreciate the jeopardy they're in, all the workers in the energy industry. But how about the fact that we're going to have to start relying on these unstable foreign sources, much of which will come from countries where there are terrorists. And they hate us and they want to shut us off. I mean, energy independence was one of the greatest things that Donald Trump did. We're the number one energy producer in the world right now for the first time in 60, 70 years. And now it's going to be ended. For what? To appease AOC and the Green New Deal? She wants to do away with commercial jet airliners. She wants to do away with cows because of their flatulence. I know she says she doesn't, but that was in their Green New Deal. Thanks for the call there, Rocky. Sticking to your New Year's resolution is a matter of making one right decision at a time, one day at a time, like they say in the 12-step programs. If you're looking to institute some healthy habits and improve your lifestyle this year, you need to check out Super Beats Heart Chews. This is something that's easy to do one day at a time. You can take a look at it. I'm holding it in my hands for the social media. They wrapped in foil like candy. They're about the size of a candy, but they taste good, but they're good for you. That's the big difference. It's easy to keep your New Year's resolution to eat healthier. Just 2 Super Beats Heart Chews per day give you the cardiovascular support and promote the heart healthy energy you need to chase your goals all year long. Super Beats Heart Chews combine non-GMO beets and clinically researched grapeseed extracts shown to be twice as effective at supporting normal blood pressure than a healthy lifestyle alone. When it comes to implementing healthy habits this year, adding Super Beats Heart Chews to your daily routine is an easy decision to make. And now you can get a free 30-day supply of Super Beats Heart Chews, plus a free 30-day supply of their new delicious flavor, Super Grapes, with your first purchase by going to superbeatsradio.com/Howie. That's 2 free gifts valued at over $50, only available at superbeatsradio.com/Howie. That's superbeatsradio.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
You can call him Fat Boy, just don't call him late for dinner.
Here's dinner Howie for you. Carr.
I want to be clear in how I characterize it. This is mostly a protest. It is not, generally speaking, unruly.
That ain't a riot, what we're seeing right now in Minneapolis.
They are strictly principled anti-fascists.
No organization is perfect. There is some violence.
Any reasonable person would say we shouldn't be destroying other people's property, but these are not reasonable times.
I argue to you tonight, all punches are not equal. Morally.
Thank goodness for the looters, man.
And please, show me where it says that protests are supposed to be polite and peaceful.
Do not get it twisted and think that, oh, this is something that has not never happened before, and then this is so terrible, and where are we, and these savages, and all of that. This is how this country was started.
People get mad, and people get sick of it. People are risking COVID to explain to this country that we're fed up.
You've been hearing me talk about Super Beats for a while now, and I'm sure some of you are still thinking, why Super Beats? You could take it from me. The benefits of Super Beats are incredible. I take them twice a day, once in the morning when I get up, even before I have my first cup of coffee, and the other time in the afternoon, right before the show. It gives me a burst of energy. It's great for my blood pressure. It's good for circulation. It just makes you feel better. If that doesn't convince you, we can talk about the science behind Super Beats. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout the body and even supports healthy blood pressure. But Super Beets does so much more than eating regular beets and is unparalleled compared to other beet powders. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of 3 whole beets. Go to superbeatsradio.com/Howie and try out Super Beets yourself. www.superbeatsradio.com/Howie. www.superbeatsradio.com/Howie.
Here's 1 minute with Governor
Charlie Parker in Massachusetts.
I'd certainly put myself on that list. I'm a basketball player. I always was.
There's a lot at stake here.
This is not a virus to be trifled with or disrespected.
Respect the virus.
I have a hard time understanding when we're going to be able to play basketball again.
We can start talking about a gradual, careful, data-driven, phased reopening. Don't let a few nice days step on that.
I need to talk to the Attorney General and find out what the actual parameters of the ruling are. Did this just happen? And the reason I read that story is because I'm a basketball player, and I agree.
I was first made aware of the discrepancy on this on the day that the registrar resigned.
The vast majority, and I mean like the vast majority of the people who are part of these protests, are there to make a
Taylor.
Point and to make it peaceful.
Let's play the rabbi one more time coming out.
Okay.
I love that. That's the best. That's the best sound cut of the day, I think.
Maybe of the month. It's a very unique voice. Speech pattern.
Yeah. Have you been looking at the text whenever we play it? What the comments
no,
that are?
No, I haven't, but I will.
Jay has a.
Hang on.
A Howie Carr Show.
Our reading for the book of Exodus about Moses is freeing us from 400 years of backbreaking Egyptian slavery at the hands of an autocratic, cruel Pharaoh.
In many ways, dear Joe, you are our Moses.
An autocratic, cruel pharaoh. That was a rabbi from Delaware and delivering a homily or a benediction or whatever you want to call it before the inauguration. That's my sound cut of the day, Taylor.
That's hard to top. sounded like a very unique individual.
And President Trump has been called so many things over the last 4 years, but never a cruel pharaoh. Let's see here. I'm going to play cut eight.
So with that, I just want to say you are amazing people. This is a great, great country. It is my greatest honor and privilege to have been your president.
Cut 10. Then we'll go back to the lines.
So just a goodbye. We love you. We will be back in some form.
I hope so. 844-500-4242. Steve, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Steve. You there? I think we lost Steve. 844-500-4242. Again, this is your last chance for our what really happened deal. If you go to our website, HowieCarrShow.com, click on store. We have a bunch of great cheap bastard deals for all kinds of different places, including Ginger Betty's in Quincy, a great bakery, and a cryo place.
If you're looking to, if you're in New Hampshire, you're looking to start firearms training or get a gun or stock up on ammo, defensive strategies. There's some of those left. Skin and Wellness, IPL Skin and Wellness in Dover, New Hampshire. Body Rituals, Wellness and Spa. Cryotherapy, like you mentioned, Howie, and you rave about that.
I love it. It's worth a try just to see if you like it. If you like it as much as I do, you'll thank me for it. And if you don't like it, you're not really out all that much money. It's good for a try.
If you like Super Beats, MD Drip, you know, getting your vitamins and your minerals and everything like that intravenously, it's like supercharged Super Beats, really.
I love that too, actually. A lot of these things are procedures that I do myself. So I think IV, you're right. I mean, it's great what you can get at IV now. And it's more effective than taking vitamins orally. So it's a good deal. So go there. Any of these half price deals for any of our cheap bastard deals, you also will get a free copy of What Really Happened. What Really Happened. Yes. 844-500-4242. And let's play a little more of Donald Trump as we go out tonight. Cut number four.
You're going to see incredible numbers start coming in if everything is sort of left alone. Be careful. Very complex. Be careful. But you're going to see some incredible things happening. And remember us when you see these things happening, if you would. Remember us.
Yeah, Trump's name will only be mentioned in the stories about the economic situation if the numbers taken unexpected turn for the worse. That's another thing that's going to be coming back is the unemployment numbers went up unexpectedly because Easter was early this year, or Easter was late this year, or Thanksgiving was early or late, depending. It doesn't matter. There's always an excuse for a Democrat president and the unexpectedly bad numbers. Paulina, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Paulina.
Hi, Howie. Love your show. Thank you so much. I just wanted to say to anyone who's listening that change is uncomfortable and we have to be willing to cut the cord like you've been talking in regards to Amazon or supporting any of these other places that we know are throwing us under the bus with glee. And it's uncomfortable, but we have to do it because that's what our president taught us. You know, we watched him go through everything he went through. And he said, you know what, I'm going to upset a lot of people, but I'm going to do what's good for
my know.
Country.
Paulina, you know, we're trying to cut the cord with Amazon. And then the mailroom manager said, hey, you know what, I like to go to Whole Foods to pick up some of the stuff she can't get at Publix, the market we usually go to across the street. And I said, you know who owns Whole Foods, right? It's Amazon. And so today I went and I got some of these, this kind of milk that she likes, this special kind of, I don't know, oat milk or something that we usually can't get it at Publix, but it was there today. So I stocked up on it so she doesn't have to go over to Whole Foods. Cause I don't want to support this crap. I mean, they killed Parler. We didn't get to those sound cuts today, but you know why they killed Parler? All the big tech got together. The boss of Parler said, because they were afraid Trump was going to come over there and he was just going to, you know, make the whole thing work all by himself. And his 65, 70, 80 million followers were all going to go over with him. So now Parler's going to get back by the end of the month, but they slowed him down. This is what they're going to do. If they can't put us out of business, they're going to make it as tough as possible. The stupid Democrat senator from Rhode Island, Sheldon Whitehouse, wants to end the nonprofit status for a Turning Point USA. We'll be back tomorrow. I'm Howie Carr.